Faithful tush.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Rooster Teeth Podcast. This week, brought to you by Blue Apron, Braintree, and Squarespace. Thank you for supporting podcast number 364. This week with Gus.
Barbara.
Birdie.
And Gus.
Someone told me on Twitter that it was 365 this week and that we'd have a year of podcasts.
That's next week.
Yeah, I'm a jerk.
That's on the leap year. We'd have a leap year podcast.
Somebody also asked me if we're going to do anything special. We're not doing anything special for that.
For what, 365?
Yeah. I mean, the stuff that we do, quote unquote, special.
During a year where there's 366 days?
Usually when we pre-plan special, it doesn't work out well. Like, stuff organically comes up.
Pancake podcast.
But that came up organically, I thought.
Did it?
Yeah, because we were like, oh, shit, this is... Gavin told us about Shrove Tuesday, and we're like, we're going to fucking make pancakes. So the next time we just made pancakes. It wasn't like we planned to have this thing. But now we plan to have it because it's fun and it's organic.
We get to eat pancakes. So the next time I looked, I was like, so next week was obviously going to be a podcast on a leap year, on a leap day. It's not going to happen again on a Monday till 2044.
So what you're saying is we should all reunite in 2044 to make it.
Wait, let Bernie think about this.
Let me think about that. So 2044, so that is... less than 30 years since this
yes.
one.
28
years. So, I'll be old. I'll be really old. You think you'll still be here, Gus? Do you think you'll still be alive, 2044?
Hopefully not.
28 years.
How old would I be? I'd be 66.
I'd be about 70.
Like
I'd be about 70.
Today's your birthday. So
today is my birthday.
How old are you today?
38.
38.
I'll live to 70.
So you'll
knock
be
on wood. Ow, that hurts.
And
you'll 66. Still You're still going to be the young one in my head.
I'm still the young one.
Are you the youngest one?
We're all just really old.
Yeah Gus is like the baby of the group, even though he's not old man.
Still is.
Gross old man. Someone decorated my office with streamers and a unicorn pinata and a birthday cake.
Were you annoyed?
I was like, this is a lot of work that someone did.
Well, okay, here's the thing. It was supposed to be for an RT life. We were going to surprise you with what you hate most, which is attention on your birthday.
I do hate that.
Why do you hate that?
I just don't think a birthday is special. It's just another day.
You didn't
it's
do anything.
It's just like, I didn't do anything. I just didn't die.
Did you notice how I didn't say happy birthday?
Thank you. That's much appreciated.
I was going to say happy Monday, but I thought that might be a little bit too
happy birthday. How old are you?
38.
38?
How many times are we going to answer that question?
I know. I just want to ask it every time because you're the baby.
You're like two 19-year-olds.
So, yeah. So I walked into the office and I saw everything. Then he immediately turned around and saw a GoPro on the wall. I was like, I know this is being filmed, and turned around, I was like, oh, there it is.
People have got to get better at hiding GoPros.
Well, we fucked up today because we were meeting in the bungalow to go over our plan for this video we were going to shoot.
What's your shirt?
It's a Donatello.
Oh. I was over here going like Teenage Mutant Ninja Cheerios or something.
No, it's a donut. Donatello.
Okay, sorry. Go ahead.
We were like in our office talking about it, and Colton's in there with a cake and all the streamers and everything that we're going to put up. And he walks out with me and Bethany, and as he's walking across the bungalow, Gus is sitting right in the fucking lobby. And I'm like, God damn it!
I saw the cake. I was like, okay, they're doing something.
And I told Bethany, I was like, Gus was right there. He saw everything. He was like, he was there? Fuck! She didn't even see you.
Sitting there typing on my laptop on the couch.
Why were you there?
I had a meeting in like a minute. It was just bad timing. Like, they walked out in, like, the 1 minute I was sitting there waiting
Gus
to go to a meeting.
Gus ruins everything.
Yeah. What was the thing where I was inviting people to dinner for Ashley's birthday, and Meg, like, I invited you, Gavin, then you invited Meg, because you go places with Meg, and then we all got together at some point after that, but before the party, and Meg goes, oh, I'm looking forward to your birthday dinner on Thursday. And I immediately just said, that was a surprise. You just ruined the surprise. And like, but it wasn't a surprise. And Meg just like, she got, am I remembering this right? Is that what happened?
You were screwing with her.
I was screwing with Meg. But I was like, immediately went into like that she had ruined Ashley's big birthday surprise.
That's the worst feeling.
Yeah. And Meg was like, no. She was so upset. She was so worried about it. But then I was just fucking with her. So now she hates me.
And now everyone knows they weren't invited to that dinner.
Who wasn't?
Anybody listening to this who wasn't invited.
When even was that? When was that?
I don't think I went. Did I go?
Ashley's
probably
birthday.
Probably not.
You were there. It was
probably
at
not.
Uchi or Uchiko.
So the Tonight Show did a set of shows in L.A. this last week.
Okay.
And I got a friend. I don't know if a friend's the right word. I know a person who is one of the producers for the show. And then somebody else we know is actually one of the writers as well. He used to write IGN and all that stuff. Anyway, the guy I know who's a producer said, hey, do you want tickets? We're going to be in L.A. If you're in L.A., why don't you come out and watch one of the shows? I was like, sure, I'll go do that. So I was going out. And Gavin turned out was going. It was like a weird thing. If he went an extra day early, he'd go with me to the show. So I said, okay, let's do it. Then like the day before, I asked him, are you coming tomorrow? And he goes, You remember what you said to me when I asked you that? I said, are you coming? Are you coming tomorrow? It's Wednesday. Tomorrow's a show in L.A. Are you coming, Gavin?
Yeah.
Remember what you said to me?
No.
You got very upset with me. You're like, why wouldn't I come? You're like, what? Why wouldn't I come? I said I was going to come. And I was like, because you do that all the time. Like, where you say you're going to come to something, and you just don't. Like, literally, you had done that the week before.
But I said I wasn't going to go.
I know, but I'm saying I was just asking to verify.
I just disappear and not show up.
No, I didn't That's expect that. I was just verifying. I was just verifying that you were going to go, and you were just I already told you
I'd booked tickets. So then you asked me if I was going. I was like, yeah, what?
To be fair, it's still a fair question from Bernie. You could still back out of that.
You could totally back
out of that. You waste a lot of money.
On what? What do I waste money on?
Being alive, betting people shit.
If you got a slow-mo guy shoot or something going, like somebody was coming in town, you wanted to shoot with them, then you would have not gone, right? You wouldn't. There we go.
Yeah, having to think about it. Have to process.
I mean, yeah, there. You can get like bumped.
You get bumped.
Okay, that's by the way, very clear, Jimmy Fallon, articulate answer from Gavin Free.
Jimmy Fallon still uses cue cards, Gus. Gavin and I were fascinated by this more than
anything
else.
Do people not really use cue cards?
Not a teleprompter. Cue cards, like a dude with cardboard cue cards.
He was just holding
during
them,
his
like,
monologue.
Them out.
Huh.
No, during the whole show. Oh, like, shit. And in fact, at one point, the guy messed up, and there was a very real moment that took place.
Did he yell at him?
Not really. He did get frustrated. That's all I'll say, because they were like, I think, because they were in L.A., there were like a lot of surprise guests. Like, they just randomly had Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Come on, because it's like, how often are they? You know, they usually shoot the show in New York, so they were shooting in L.A. this time.
Who was on? Who was on the episode you saw?
Vince Vaughn was on, and he was very, 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 very funny.
I love that guy.
Very funny dude.
He was the best part of the show.
He was the best part of the show, I would say. And he did like one of the, you know, the Jimmy Fallon show, they just play a bunch of games.
Yeah.
That's what they do now.
Mm-hmm.
Like
I'm jealous of their games.
Like with
really?
The guests?
Yeah.
Like yeah, they just play games.
I think about like On
games.
The Spot and like shows we do, and like all the games they do are really good.
Mm-hmm. Like they did the... What was it called? The Lie in a Box?
Oh, I saw
Box
that.
Of Lies.
I never watched a Tonight Show. I saw that episode.
With Vince Vaughn.
It was a, what was it? Like a Hulk in jelly beans or something? Yeah.
That's Wait, weird. So you know the episode we're talking about?
Yeah, I saw, like I was.
And it only just clicked?
Yeah, well, I didn't realize it was Vince Vaughn until he said that game.
What was the game?
So you get they are behind a divider and they can see each other's faces and that's it. And they each get a box off of like this three shelves that have 9 boxes on it. Then without the other person seeing, they can pull it out and show the audience what's in their box.
Uh-huh.
Then the game is they tell them what was in the box, and the other person has to guess whether or not they're telling the truth or they're lying. And so the items are really strange, and they try to come up with something stranger. Like Vince Vaughn, he went first. He got an action figure of the Incredible Hulk, and an action doll, and it was on a bed of crayons like that were all tied together.
Mm-hmm.
And Jimmy Fallon's was a taco with gumdrops in it instead of like taco meat. It had gumdrops.
Okay.
And so... Vince Vaughn described his perfectly, and Jimmy Fallon goes, "You're lying." Got a point for Vince Vaughn. Jimmy Fallon said that his taco was actually a ruler made out of celery, right? Was that what it was?
Which is a funny lie.
It is a funny lie. It is very funny. And but Vince Vaughn was in his head and like knew that he was lying. So
that's a really fun game.
I was really impressed by Fallon's little lap of victory at the end of the show. Like he went around like hugging all the audience and stuff and got like caked in makeup.
He got covered by like he had a black or dark suit on. He was like covered in people's makeup from giving them hugs.
Weird.
Yeah.
I guess like they were sitting down, or like how did you get makeup on?
Well, I mean,
girls are short.
Girls are shorter. He's a tall dude.
He just like got like
he's tall.
His face.
I always picture him being like I see him on TV. I picture him like 5'8", 5'9", tall.
Everybody there was tall. They also had I didn't even know this was the case. They have a Grateful Dead reunion band, but it's like since Jerry Garcia's dead, they have John Mayer. Did you know this?
No.
It's called Dead & Company. I had no clue that was a thing. And John Mayer, also, super tall. It was like the night of like super tall people.
And Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Kareem
really
Abdul-Jabbar.
Tall.
Go figure.
How tall do you think Jimmy Fallon is? Let's guess.
I'm going to stick with 5'9", even though you told me he's tall.
All right,
I'm going to say 5'10".
That's one of the most common things I feel like people tell me, like when they meet me in person or when they see me somewhere in an event, they always say, "You're much taller than I thought you would be."
Because you're always sitting down on everything you're
and
in.
I get it both. I get you're much shorter and you're much taller.
Hmm.
It goes both ways. And your nose is much bigger or much smaller.
It says that Jimmy Fallon is 6 foot.
Okay.
Even. I have a tough time believing that. Vince Vaughn I know is taller than that for sure.
Yeah, Vince Vaughn I picture being really tall. I picture him like
6'5".
Six four. Five.
Ah,
there you go.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Oh, what's that Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's real name? Did he convert?
I think you're thinking of,
He's 7'2", Gavo.
What?
Yeah, wow.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Can I have a beer?
I'm thinking of Cassius Clay for sure. But yeah, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar was born Ferdinand Louis Alcindor.
Yeah, that's right.
Lou Alcindor. Yep. And
so different.
Well, yeah, he converted to, I guess, Islam in the.
But
70s.
Even his first name, he changed.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Yep. I think that's what he did. Let me see here. Up, up. Six-time most valuable player.
Tall so was dude. He only famous as Kareem? Or was he famous before?
I remember Lou Alcindor. Hmm. Like, do you know Muhammad Ali's original name?
You just said it.
I did?
Cassius Clay.
Okay, good.
Did he say it?
I don't think he said it.
I think I almost said it.
I swear he just said Cassius Clay. I mean, I knew that.
Maybe in your head you said it, because you were thinking about it.
You're probably just, your brain probably just auto-completed.
Roll the tape!
Is it me, or is autocorrect getting way worse?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Like, it is fucking with me on a daily basis.
You mean it's ducking
Siri
with you?
Siri can never do anything it's for me, with me anymore.
Can I try this right now?
Sure.
Call Gavin Free.
Calling Gavin Free.
Wow. Well, stirring audio podcast.
We don't have good reception in here. Is it calling? Is it ringing?
Sorry, Bernie. I can't make your phone call.
She says that for everything now. She can't do anything anymore for me. She recognizes my commands, like send a message to Gus, anything like that. What time is it? She's like, I can't help you.
Are you not connected to Wi-Fi?
No, she just it's a thing that happens with these iPhones now, and if I reboot, then she'll be fine.
Set a timer for 10 minutes. She won't?
Set a timer for 10 minutes.
Setting the timer.
There you go.
Yeah, great. Waiting. Siri.
Twitter says that he did say.
Uh oh, something's wrong.
What the fuck?
She doesn't do shit for me anymore.
Bitch.
I can't count
Siri's
to 10.
Getting dumber. Every time I talk to Siri, she gets dumber.
Twitter does say that he did say Cassius Clay.
I knew it. Thanks, Twitter. You're better than the
Thank
tape.
Thank you, Liam Slatcher.
So I got a replacement phone.
Speaking of the tape, I got
because I cracked my last one.
TV setup. But go ahead.
And I bricked it last week, which is cool. By the way, everyone was freaking out about that. Fixed it in like 5 minutes when I got home.
How?
You just
restored it.
There's like a firmware re-upload mode you can put
People
in.
People were very upset with you about that.
Why?
Like, I have no idea why.
Is it because
it was my
wasteful?
Old phone?
Because it seemed wasteful, even though he said very clearly he was done with that phone.
Yeah.
He had a replacement phone already, and he just needed to ship it back.
Is it because people thought he was just ruining the phone altogether? Where it
I don't
been
know.
Sold back
I've made it pretty clear that my other phone was like 10 feet away. Anyway, this new replacement phone I've got is crap. Like, it's the exact same model, same gigabytes. Same exact phone.
What's crap about it?
It's really hot all the time. The battery goes down twice as fast.
Yep.
And the keyboard mistypes like 100% more. Like I misspell stuff. It's like I got dumb with this phone. I don't know what that is.
Like maybe like it's like, offset just a little bit or something.
I have no idea.
Doesn't have to relearn your typing skills? Or
what's
your
it
like
learning? I mean, I press A and it puts in a B. Well, not B, but whatever's near an A on the keyboard.
So I would. This is normally the point at which I would say, okay, somebody find out, like they just announced the Galaxy 7, is that right? They just came out with that?
Yeah.
Just unveiled the specs for it or whatever. And I would say, all right, I'm going to make this switch to Android. I'm doing it. I'm moving over. However, my ex, Jordan, she just moved from an iPhone to a Samsung phone, an Android phone. It's been a fucking nightmare for everybody. And actually, Gavin helped me figure out what it was. It's the thing where no we can messenger.
It's still registered on iMessage.
It must be that it's still registered on iMessage. Yeah. So hopefully we can get her phone back and like figure that out.
There's
somehow.
A website I think you can go to
mm-hmm.
that de-links that phone number from iMessage.
I will die.
So she can't receive or send out text messages?
She had an iPhone for years. So when I would send her messages from my iPhone, she was blue. So she was registered with the iMessage service, which is different than SMS. The problem is when she switched over to Android, I think this is what's taking place. Anybody with an iPhone can no longer message her. But that's because everyone already has her as an iMessage person.
Yeah.
So it's sending it to her iMessage account at Apple, and Apple's going like, well, the phone's not online. I'll just wait for it to come online, and I'll deliver the message. So, but her phone will never come back online because she's off on another platform now.
That's really annoying.
Yeah, there's like significant procedures to go through when you switch away from an iPhone.
It's been horrible, like trying to
make it hard on you.
So I had to switch like everybody in the whole family over to like a new chat service.
I like that you did that instead of just turning off iMessage though.
No, I didn't. I totally, for whatever reason, I didn't even think about it until after that. Until, like, we were in the car, like, literally the moment you started talking about it, I was like, oh, yeah, this is the iMessaging problem that we already knew about. That was such a stupid nightmare for Apple. But I'll try it. It might work. It might not. She also can't send messages to people either. They don't come in.
Only if it's iPhone or anybody.
I don't know. She's not. I only have iPhone, so it's only coming to my
Why
way.
Does she switch off an iPhone?
I don't know why she did it. She hated her new iPhone. It was like dropping dead on her and stuff and everything.
I don't blame her.
Yeah.
It's a terrible term.
Autocorrect is way worse.
Yeah, but
I'm so sorry about all this.
Sorry.
If something happened in the last week or in the last 2 weeks.
Nah.
Because it is 10 times worse.
Like something
it just,
has happened.
I will be typing. I will type a sentence that is grammatically correct, and then it will change one of the words.
Turn off
it thinks,
autocorrect.
I'm at this point where I'm going to have to. It'll change a word in the sentence I typed to be grammatically incorrect, and it thinks it's right.
Yeah,
how the fuck does it do
sometimes
that?
Sometimes I'll type your, and it'll change it to apostrophe R-E, and I'll keep typing. I'll be like, what? That's not even... Not only does it not make grammatical sense now, it's like you should be doing that the other way.
Right.
I assume it does. What is it doing?
Nah, I don't know.
Do you have predictive text on? That thing that, like, little
Teddy
pops
loves
up.
That thing. Yeah. He just sends me messages all day via predictive text.
Yeah. Just, like, really it makes funny. Up a sentence.
Yeah, it makes up a sentence.
Because if you have that and no autocorrect, it's perfect. You don't need anything else.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't use the predictive stuff. It just seems like more hassle than typing
out
the entire word.
But, like, half of your email responses are predictive
responses. Oh, no. I have an email client that, like, does predictive, like, responses.
Oh, those are great.
Like, hey, thanks for the message. That's great. I'll look into that. And it's like, I can just hit a button and send that email back. It's like, it's great. Probably 50% of my emails that I send now are like that. They're like, great, thanks for the heads up.
I have those too, and I always feel guilty when I send one of those. Like,
I used to. I don't
anymore. Does the person receiving this know? Do they know that I put literally no effort into this message? I just clicked one thing.
If yours has an exclamation point, it probably is because it's pre-done.
Yeah.
I don't know, like, you could never
okay,
tell.
Great. That's one of them I use all
the time. Some of them are like really custom. Some of them are like, okay, Monday at 9, see you then.
Yeah.
And it's like,
like it finds the information in the email and like sends it. You know, the email client that I'm using, I think you use the same one. There's another version of it that if there was a date in the email, it would link me to my calendar.
Yep.
And
it creates an event for you.
My current one doesn't do that though. One doesn't do that.
Yeah.
I'll tell you about it afterwards.
I'm having that problem also.
Are you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How do you use, I don't know why we're not saying the name of this client, how do you use Google Drive with it?
You don't either.
Sucks.
Yeah.
How am I missing stuff?
It's missing functionality.
There are some key bits of functionality missing. So it's missing that. It's missing the ability to unflag something as spam. So if you find something in your spam folder that's not spam, you cannot unflag it. And
you just transfer it back to your inbox?
No. You can transfer it, but you can't tell it this was not actually spam.
Really? Ah,
you also cannot block recipients. So if you want to block recipients, you have to go to a different mail program, block
them.
Very
specific Gus problem.
And then come over.
Who wants to block people from email?
There are, some people who do not get, I do not get their email anymore. There are some people who are just like, I am not reading anything you say.
I knew it.
I can block this person and my life will be better.
Are you talking about people at the company?
I've never blocked anybody at the company, but I've blocked people outside of the company.
One day I want to go through, like if I feel really bold, I will go through my mute filter that I have on Twitter. Probably 50% of the people that I have on Twitter I've muted. I also blocked. There's a dude on Twitter right now saying, hey, Gus, block me. Can you tell him to unblock me and please tell him happy birthday for me? First of all, people do this on a regular basis. They write me to tell somebody else at the company to unblock them.
People do that for you all the time.
I would never do that. Only because I block people about 3 or 4 times a day. Literally, it's like I use block like a downvote button.
What's your criteria for it?
Just if I don't like, I just don't like what the person
said. Probably.
To you?
Like literally, it's like, hey dude, you look like this dude I just saw at a coffee shop. I don't like anything like that dude. Block. It's like,
wow,
literally.
Really?
Absolutely.
I think in my life, I've blocked less than 5 people.
I can see. A week. So I'm not
as
crazy as Burton.
I mute more people than I block.
So I am against the mute functionality in Twitter.
Why?
Because if I don't want to hear what someone has to say, I want them to know that I'm not listening. I feel like mute is a pussy way out. You're like, oh, I'm going to pretend like I like you and I'm following you, but I'm really not listening.
You're on fucking social media,
go nuclear,
tough guy.
Unsubscribe. Unfollow. Don't listen to that shit.
Also, I like to think of someone who, like, you unfollow sitting at home and Gus unfollowed
me.
That's
probably Jack.
If there was an option, there's an option for unfollow.
Wait, did you unfollow Jack?
I unfollowed Jack.
Recently?
I unfollowed you. I defriended you on Facebook because you kept accepting too many friend invites.
Yeah.
Like this person literally said, "Hey Bernie, haha, can you ask Gus to block me?" And I'm blocking that person because I don't like the joke.
If there was an option,
it's Barbara. That's my criteria.
False unfollow with notification. Would you use that?
Yes.
It would send them a message.
Yes, and to prove my point, I stopped accepting all those friend requests, didn't I? I had bad behavior that got corrected
you
as
did.
A result.
I also don't.
It's like smacking a dog with a newspaper in the face.
Ah.
You know what another great function?
Beat the shit out of an animal.
But you're the animal in this case.
Damn right.
Have you ever hit your dog with a newspaper?
God no.
Oh my god.
I would never
it's
hit
like
my
his
dog.
Baby.
Well, because he's like,
they're tiny.
Yeah.
Like fling it out the window.
You'd end up in the news. Just like be on one of the pages. Like,
It seems like when they sell you a Samsung phone, they should tell you the iMessaging thing. Like, that should be something that,
Honestly, I'm pretty sure they do.
Run by
I think they have a whole, like, kit for that.
Yeah.
I think Apple has, I think they were sued, and I think they even have a website where you have to go through to deregister from iMessage.
I have a question for you.
All right, deregister.
You don't mute people on Twitter, but do you ever mute people's retweets? You could do that.
No.
You don't never mute retweets from people.
If someone retweets too much, unfollow.
There's a lot of people, who retweet retweeting too much. Every fucking thing that people say to them.
Yeah, I've unfollowed. I try to keep it small. Like, I want, if I follow someone, I really want to know what they're saying.
I mute people.
There has to be substance in the bulk of their tweets.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Wait, do you still follow me?
I do follow you.
Okay.
You don't mute. I mute retweets sometimes.
I don't.
All the time.
Do you see my tweet yesterday?
I do it a lot as well.
About my plane that I was on?
Oh, yeah.
Are you okay if people mute your retweets?
I follow you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like, hey, thank you for following me and what I have to say. I'm retweeting something someone else is saying. I don't know. It's, you know, I appreciate the people who read those, but it's not a necessity.
Yeah. We always get this stupid. The social media is like the stupidest thing in the world to talk about. It's just so funny. It's the dumbest thing that all of us do.
It's my job.
It's the dumbest thing, Barbara.
You rope
it's
us into it every
job.
Week.
It's, what's that?
You rope us in.
I know. It's like so dumb to talk about.
Let's
set a bet right now. Podcast 364, February 22nd, 2016. How long until Twitter goes out of business? How long until Twitter is no longer available as a platform?
As a platform, like gone? Like, oh man. Would Dig count as being in that category? Is Dig still going?
I would say Dig is gone because it does not exist. It does not exist in the same form.
Yeah. I'm going to give it 8 years.
Oh, okay.
We're 10 years in at this point almost. We're like 9 years, 8 years?
Until it's no longer available to use. 8 years.
It is six. I reckon my last tweet will be 4 years from now.
You got a guess?
What's everybody doing? Everybody's going to Snapchat?
Eight, six.
Fuck.
I don't even know. I can't guess.
I'm going to say four.
4 years?
Four. By January 1st, 2020. Gone.
How long before it's no longer your primary social media platform?
Oh, I bet that it'll be...
2 years?
Yeah, 2 years before that happens.
2 years, huh?
I mean, they experience no growth, right?
What are you going to?
Nothing. I'm done.
Yeah, me too. I'm with you guys. So let's just do our own platform. It's just me and you.
Liars.
Just
messages. You guys are such liars.
We can constantly follow and unfollow each other.
That's it. Yeah. As you
guys
say,
all mouth, the both of you.
All mouth.
But I haven't moved. Mouth. So there's been.
So Gavin's in the car the other day. Has the epiphany. He has the epiphany where he goes, I think I'm going to concentrate on Instagram more. Or what was that? What was it you said?
Yeah, I was like.
Everybody go follow Gavin on Instagram. What are you, Gavin Free?
Yeah.
He has one picture.
He has one
picture. Well, I'm thinking about doing my second picture.
Is it going to be of your knee?
It will be of my elbow. Thank you for asking. And I want it to be like 5 years after my knee.
Could it be like the inside of your elbow that looks like boobs or a butt?
So if you go follow Gavin on Instagram right now, you would be ahead of the curve. You'd be like, oh my gosh, I was in when it was one photo.
I want to keep like a really high post to follower ratio.
You have the dumbest criteria for everything.
You
just the absolute dumbest. It's the stuff that only matters to you.
It's funny.
It's like Gavin wanted to buy like his first car. He thought it would be funny if he waited until autonomous cars come out, and that way he had never ever driven his own car.
Because I wanted to say
his whole life.
No. I wanted to get an electric car so I could say I never like polluted by driving.
I don't remember you saying that. You said it would be funny.
Yeah.
Storytelling. Like, nobody cares about that story. It's just you asking other people for rides all the time.
Well, like, it was funny.
That's a story.
It's hilarious.
I like doing stuff that's funny to talk about afterwards. Like, it's funny that I went to Australia for a day.
Oh, my gosh. That was pretty amazing that you did that, honestly.
That's hilarious.
It was a little more than a day.
Was the trip to Sundance that you took, would you think it was worth it?
Yeah, I had a good time.
It was worth it? Okay. Because it was, like, he was already booked to go to Australia. Then the Laser Team promotional thing came up with YouTube Red, and he was then called away to Sundance into his Australia trip.
Well, I was told I wouldn't be able to go to Australia.
You were like, a fucking champion.
I could go for, like, just a little bit.
Who was it that ruined it? Was it Funhouse?
Surprised
that you were there?
Yeah.
Stupid Funhouse. Did you do anything fun while you were at Sundance? Did you, like, go sledding down one of those stupid mountains or anything?
No.
Ski?
No. Didn't do anything.
Oh, they have, like, sledding and stuff. Did you go skiing?
I went, I bought a bath bomb for Meg.
From Sundance?
From like Salt Lake.
Sounds like
it was made from like the Salt Lake. The Great Salt Lake.
I remember the first year went out there, we went, I think in 05 maybe, 04 or 05. We went out there and I think
pissed a hole through the snowman?
Yeah, I think that was the second time we went. Okay. But the first time we went out there, we all severely underestimated how fucking cold it would be.
Yeah.
We got out there and it was like, holy shit. Yep. And we all immediately went to the store and bought like additional jackets.
I still have that jacket.
Me too.
I still have that.
I use that one as a rain jacket still to this
day. Yeah, I came straight from the summer of Australia, so I was walking around in the snow in like Converse and shorts.
Didn't Gavin not, don't you not own a winter jacket?
I do, it's in England. Oh. I didn't think it would be smart to bring a winter coat to Texas.
It gets kind of cold here.
It gets hoodie cold. It doesn't get like...
It was not very cold. It was not very cold.
This winter, no. But other winters, it's gotten below freezing.
I keep waiting for it. I keep waiting for it to like... I keep waiting for winter to start and not realizing we're at the end of it already.
Shh, don't say it too loud.
It's like it's gone. It's not happening.
The last 3 months were the hottest months on record in as long as we've been recording it. Since the late 1800s.
We keep breaking records too often and we should stop talking about it.
But we should stop talking about the fact that
do you think it's hot?
No, I mean, it's just like a given at this point. It's ruined.
Are we breaking a record for talking about records being broken?
I don't know. It's just like, I feel like every month it's like, that was the hottest month. That was the coldest day in that month. You know, it just happens all the time.
So records are just like, who cares now?
They're just too easily broken.
Well, maybe what'll happen is we'll break them to such a degree that then it'll become memorable in the future. And then it'll be like, I remember when that happened.
All the people in the ice age.
Right. Once everything rubber bands back.
Yeah.
Here, let me read this.
So we come back from this ad. I recorded a video of my TV so that I can explain to these two jerks what my TV looks like.
I can't.
Patrick, do you have that?
I haven't received anything.
He has not received it.
You want to
walk it over there?
Yeah, just plug in lightning cable.
I'm going to walk. I hate walking.
Go walk.
Go do it.
Walk right in front of Gus's camera.
I'm going to wait for him to clear camera, and then I'll start reading.
Good.
I'm good?
Go for it.
He's gonna fucking block me. There he goes.
Yep.
Motherfucker. All right. Want to remind everyone this episode of the podcast? All right. Want to remind everyone this episode of the podcast is brought to you by Blue Apron. You need to know how to cook. Not only do you feel like you know your way around the kitchen, but cooking at home means eating healthier and saving money instead of ordering expensive takeout again. But where do you start? Blue Apron has you covered. For less than $10 per meal, Blue Apron delivers all the fresh ingredients you need to create home-cooked meals. Just follow the easy step-by-step instructions. Each meal can be prepared in 40 minutes or less. No overwhelming trips to the grocery store. No more sad takeout. No matter your dietary preferences, Blue Apron makes it a breeze to discover and prepare dishes like steaks. I don't know how to say that. Steaks, some French steaks. Or cauliflower cheesesteak sandwiches right in your own kitchen. Cook with ingredients that you've never used before, like watermelon radishes, farro, and purple potatoes. Recipes are between 500 and 700 calories per portion. Delicious and good for you. Right now, you can get your first two meals free at blueapron.com/roosterteeth. That's blueapron.com/roosterteeth. Blue Apron, a better way to cook. Thank you, Blue Apron, for sponsoring the pot. What the hell is going on over here? I look at the iPad for a minute, and then I come back, and Barbara's getting crushed.
Why are your eyes crying?
Barbara's like dying in there.
I couldn't breathe.
Are you okay? Yeah, tears are streaming down Barbara's face. She looks red.
I crushed the liquid out.
You crushed the tears out? Just like squeezed her?
Yeah. Coming out the freshly top. Squeezed Barbara.
You got it?
I'll use the Hitler
so
pillow
last
to
week,
dry my tears.
We were talking about Bernie's ridiculous...
I said Patrick, but it's not ready to go.
Oh.
It'll be a little while before it's ready to go.
Okay.
All right. So you know what I learned?
Let me get to that. I'm really curious to see this video.
Me too.
I'm not.
I'm curious for you to see it.
What did you learn?
So, last week was leg two of the Amazing Race, and we went to Colombia as part of it. Cartagena.
Colombia.
I loved everyone mispronouncing it.
Cartagena. You know, I can't make too much fun because they don't show it on the show. It's too confusing of a narrative. But a lot of your flights, you will have connections because there's not a lot of Mexico City to Cartagena flights. But you can fly from Mexico City to Bogota and then fly from Bogota to Cartagena, which is actually what happened. Most of us connected through. So it showed us as like all being on one flight together. That was the connection flight that some people made their way onto, but other people did not.
Okay.
I was actually on a flight with the models, and then they got on a later flight from the connection, so we had to split up at some point. Anyway, at the very beginning of the episode, they cut to the middle of a conversation between me and Ashley. It was like, hey, we're going to a whole new continent, because when I started The Amazing Race, I had not been to South America, I had not been to Antarctica, and I had not been to Africa. So I was hoping I would go to one of those, probably not Antarctica, because I've never been to Antarctica, as far as I know on the show. But I was hoping I would go to one of them, and then right out of the gate, we go to South America, so now I have one more continent checked off. Turns out, I can't say everybody in South America, but a lot of schools in South America don't teach that South America is a separate continent than North America.
What?
That it's one giant America continent, and that the North and South are just political, geopolitical borders. I was like, because the first person who came at me goes, yes, South America is a continent. Way to go, Bernie. That's why people think Americans are stupid. I'm like, what are you, a fucking asshole? It's like, South America is its own continent. Go look it up. But apparently a lot of places in South America has got other messages all week long.
So, which is correct. One of them has to definitively be correct.
If I think about it, technically, it's one continuous landmass.
Well, it's
the only thing that breaks it up is the Panama Canal, which is a man-made thing.
Okay.
Well, so are Europe and Asia.
Yeah.
But some people call that Eurasia.
Well, those people
and some people call
silly
that other continent Australasia instead of Australia. We've had this discussion before.
Yeah, that's what's going to lead to is in the UK we learned they don't teach that Australia is its own continent.
Right.
Yeah. It's part of a bigger continent that includes all the islands and stuff around all the other countries.
Australasia.
Yeah, Australasia. There you go. But I thought that was really interesting. It's like so do some schools teach us like five continents and that's it? Like I would imagine too that Europe and Asia can't be considered separate in any way, even though we consider them to be separate continents.
They're totally separate.
How? No, I disagree, actually. I always wondered that as a kid. Like, why is Europe a continent?
No, I mean, like, North and South America. I'm thinking about North and South America. Totally
separate.
Yeah,
but why, though, if you think about it? Why would they be two separate continents?
There could be two plates hitting each other.
So, once again, we're back to the tectonic
discussion.
Or two plates
pulling away from each other.
Is it the landmass or is it the tectonic plates? What determines
the tectonic plate?
Tectonic plates.
Oh, I disagree with that, but okay. You're saying that's what determines if something's a continent.
Right, and that's why Australasia exists. Because it's all on the same tectonic plate.
Bitch.
Thank you, Gavin. I appreciate that.
I just like saying tectonic plate.
I appreciate that bit of color commentary. So what happened to your plane?
Oh, my God, yeah. I was, I'm like, super tired at the moment. So I was half asleep when it happened. The plane took off. I'm actually, like, really good now at falling asleep before the plane takes off.
A continent is defined as a large, unbroken landmass.
Fuck you, Gavin.
Completely surrounded by water. Although in some cases, continents are connected by land bridges. The seven continents are North America, South America, Europe, Asia, Africa, Australia, and Antarctica. It says nothing about tectonic plates. It says an unbroken landmass.
It does say North and South America, though.
Surrounded by water.
And
that's
Europe
how I learned
Asia.
It when I was a kid. Landmass, massive landmass, surrounded by water.
But it says Europe and Asia.
It does say Europe and Asia. It does say North America and South America, too. But if you think about it, North America and South America are an unbroken landmass.
So then how does Australasia make any sense? Because that's not connected in any sort of way.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm so confused.
Here's why.
All of that under ocean plate.
Here's why Gav learned that Australia is not its own continent. It used to be a British colony, so they're upset. They don't want to give it full continent status. It's definitely like, I can definitely see being like a UK
that's
thing.
It's like their little payback.
Right. The UK is not its own continent, so Australia couldn't possibly be its own continent.
Does the sun still never set on the British Empire?
I'm pretty sure it sets now.
Damn it. How do we mess that up? So, I was asleep before we took off.
It's the best.
And then
it is the best.
When a plane takes off and you're asleep, you kind of like zone back in temporarily, but you're just like, oh yeah, it's good. We're going to take off now. And then we were apparently like 105 miles an hour on the runway, and he just slammed the brakes. And everyone like slid forward. And I was like, I went down like this.
It's really scary.
And everyone was like opening the shutters. And I was like, was there a plane in front of us? And then we swerve right off the runway, like the next available path.
You hadn't lifted up yet, had you?
What?
No, we were still on
the ground. And we just pulled like hard off the runway. And he just came on saying, stay in your seats. And then we kept driving. And then he was like, the tower just told him to abort, like as he was taking off. But
Why?
It was below the speed where you have to take off, because
right.
we could still stop. But it was above a certain speed where they had to do a maintenance check on the plane to check for damage to the brakes and stuff.
Mm. How long did that take?
Took forever. It was like another. It was. I think it took the length that the flight should have been. Again, so it was like 2.5 hours.
Did you ever wait on the plane the whole time to let you deplane?
Yeah, they told us not to get off. We went back to the gate. We actually went back to a different gate. There were no gates for a while. We went back to the gate. But when I tweeted it saying we're above a certain speed and we had to go back to the gate for maintenance, people thought that was the reason the plane like aborted takeoff. It's because we were going too fast.
You went too fast.
Like so many people were like, I've never heard of a plane like having to.
Did they end up telling you why they had to abort?
Yeah, the tower just like picked up something on the ground radar or something.
Or maybe like.
And it was a false alarm, but they have to report it every time. They have to abort planes.
Better safe than sorry.
If anything like that happens.
Yeah.
It was cool. I mean, it wasn't cool. It sucked. It like ruined half my day.
I imagine that would be a terrible feeling to feel as your plane's getting ready to take off.
I mean, I probably would have been fine with it. It's just the fact that I was half asleep. It was so jarring to wake up from. Yeah. Like, I like slid down. Like, it was that forceful.
You weren't buckled in?
I was. It was just like, it was kind of loose, you know? You know how you sit on a plane. You're not like, no, I wasn't first class.
Those seats are slippery.
I was bulkhead, so my knees hit the wall.
Oh, God. I'm so happy a new season of Air Disaster started last night. Oh, yeah? I saw it was on my DVR. I was like, ooh.
You're so weird.
Gonna watch that soon.
How do you like that stuff?
It's really interesting.
I wouldn't be able to watch that without being terrified every time I flew.
You know, I got to admit something embarrassing.
What?
So someone just sent me this thing saying it's correct that continents are determined by tectonic plates. But Europe and Asia are on the same fucking plate.
No, they're not.
They are. I'm looking at
They collide. That's why there's mountains, the Ural Mountains.
That would make sense. I understand what you're saying. No. Not according to this hand-drawn map from Wikipedia.
That looks like that is totally accurate.
Sound.
Looks like it came out of MS Paint. So I'm going to block you, Vixen, for embarrassing me on the podcast.
What's your embarrassing admission?
I'm retweeting this. Now you're just going to be shamed forever. Retweet.
Go ahead.
I really have like free time to just watch Netflix. But when I got back, Meg was still in Long Beach doing a convention, so I was like, I'm gonna watch something on Netflix. And then I remember you told me about Charlie Victor Romeo.
Yeah.
So I started typing it in. Charlie, and then Charlie's Angels popped up, and I was like, I haven't seen that movie in like 10 years, and I watched that instead.
Is that the first one?
Yeah. Oh, it sucks. It's a bad movie.
What's the best movie you've seen recently?
Best movie I've seen recently. I don't know. I feel like I've been disappointed by a lot. Maybe Firewatch. Star Wars Episode 7.
Deadpool is pretty good.
Play Firewatch?
I've not played Firewatch yet. I've been still playing fucking XCOM 2.
Stop. I'm still playing Just Cause 3.
It is so goddamn hard.
I think I spent on my treadmill playing Just Cause 3 last night. I did. I like did a thing where I stumbled off the right side, and then my foot went off the treadmill, so it was lower than my left foot. And then to catch myself, I like tried to like do the pull spread eagle over the treadmill, but it was too wide. So I had my left foot on the part of the treadmill that doesn't move. My right foot was all the way across and down on the floor, and then I was falling forward.
Oh, God. The treadmill's
still going like, it's still going like 7 miles an hour. Now it wasn't that fast because I was walking. So it was like 5 miles an hour. But it was like, it was still going. And I was like trying to catch myself and my knees lowering. And my knee went, no, no, no. And it went zip, sandpaper, like took the top of my like knee off.
Oh,
I want to see.
You want to see?
I'll show you.
See your knee.
Could you even roll up those pants? Are they loose enough?
These pants are really cool. These pants are Japanese twill. I got them from one of our sponsors.
Ooh.
So that's blue apron. Look at that.
Oh, you really did yourself. That's like a playground.
I feel like I used to get scrapes like that all the time when I was a kid.
What are you, 9?
I have not had a scrape like that.
Look at this, Gavin. It's funny you say that because I skinned my other knee. So I have two skinned knees right now.
It looks like a nipple on your knee.
It does?
Your knee looks like a little booby.
It will heal right because it's like, they're like sanded down to the bone, I think, or something.
What if your tits were on your knees?
$1 million butt.
It would be like so weird.
I thought the perfect $1 million butt question for you.
Yeah.
Did you need a bra?
Hey, baby. Yeah.
That question I've been asking people lately, because it wouldn't be good to film.
Feed your kids under the table.
Feed what? What do you think Gus's answer to that question would be? That $1 million butt question I've been asking lately.
The one you asked me?
Yeah, the test one. Should I use that for an episode, first of all?
The test one.
I said the really dark one. Mentally dark. $1 million butt question. I just asked it literally before the podcast. Gus wasn't here.
Yeah. Is it the same one that I'm thinking of?
I think it is. I don't know what you're thinking of. Gavin, help me out.
Gee, Brian, what do you want to do tonight?
What do you think Gus would answer that question?
I don't think he'd take it.
There's no way Gus would take it.
Why not? What? I want to know what it is now.
Do you think that's good enough to use in an episode? I don't, because I don't think it can be filmed.
I don't honestly think I know which one you're talking about.
I just asked it to Blaine.
Yeah, that one, yeah.
Yeah, that one we can't film. Can we film that one? I know, it's tough.
Why are people looking at me?
It's tough, Gus. Should I ask Gus now is what I'm saying, or should I wait and leave it for an episode? Gus, here's my question. Fuck off, Gavin. God damn, I cannot get a straight answer out of him. Okay, Gus, you get $1 million, and everyone in the world gets to pick a superpower of their choice, which they get for the rest of their life.
It is the one I was thinking of.
Gus would never pick that.
But you don't get a superpower. Everybody else does. You just get the $1 million.
Could I use the superpower to get $1 million?
What superpower?
Oh, I guess I wouldn't have it either way.
You have no superpower.
Yeah, sure. Of course I take that.
You take $1 million, but everyone else in the world has a superpower except for you.
Let's say I take invisibility and I come and steal your fucking money.
Jesus, you said that so threatening.
I steal your fucking money.
I would just spend it before you could do it.
You would take $1 million to basically be the lamest person on earth.
I would be unique at that point.
He's already doing that for free.
Wow.
All excellent right, point, Barbara.
Happy birthday.
What if everybody, like, nobody knew that you were the person who made the decision that gave them superpowers, but everyone did know that you passed up on superpowers to take $1 million instead? Like, everyone was aware of that fact.
Sure.
Like, you're the one guy on the earth who took $1 million instead of taking the money.
Yeah, that's fine.
Or instead of taking the power.
Yeah.
Really? Barbara, would you do that?
No.
No way.
No.
I wouldn't do it in a million years.
100%
I'm trying to
no.
think, like, which prick am I paying $1 million to when I want to buy something? Like, there's going to be a superhero car salesman?
Yeah.
He's just lifting the cards up. Yeah.
I think the money wouldn't even work
because
you'd be like, I need to get a plane ticket to Brazil because I'm a millionaire and I want to take a nice trip. I'm going to go to Brazil. And they'd be like, no, there's no more flights to Brazil because 33% of the people there can now fly. So
yeah.
It's like,
yeah, but 66% of the people still need to get on a plane.
But they probably know a dude that can fly them around.
Or Brazilian lava dude destroyed Brazil.
I could probably know a dude who could fly me around then.
I just thought of a great idea for an RT short. It's Uber for superpowers. Like for the shittiest.
Suba?
Yep. It's like shitty superpower people, and there's an Uber app to just call, like, you don't know exactly what it is until they accept it.
Like, your cat's stuck in a tree, and you're just like, Suber it?
Yeah, and then Gus shows up, like, hi, I'm, like, Acid Man. It's like, no, fuck.
You gotta wait for me to melt the tree down.
Yeah, he's gotta, like, slowly melt through
just
it.
Just make sure the cat does not touch me.
How long before that's a BuzzFeed short, now that I've said
it
out loud on the fucking internet?
Yeah, I'm sure they're all over it.
Can I ask you another question?
Yeah.
Yes.
Is there anything in your head that you have established in your head as being a certain price and you know that's wrong, but that's still the price of the thing in your head?
Anal.
Let me give you my example. A price of a hotel room in my head is $80. That's how much a hotel room costs a night. It's not right.
No way.
And every time I load up, like, to book a hotel room somewhere, I'm always mad that this hotel room is, like, $170. And I'm like, that's so expensive. But that's exactly what hotels cost.
It's actually pretty cheap for a room
now. Like,
$130.
Yeah. If you go stay in L.A., it's like, the rooms are like, a room is $500 a night.
Starts at $300 and goes up from there.
Holy cow. That's crazy. That's why Airbnb is great. You're like, two or three bedrooms, and you're good to go.
We did that for
but do you have anything like that? Because that's the thing I know I have wrong in my head. And every time I encounter it, I try to correct my thinking on it, and I can't. It's just a hotel room should cost $79.
For me, maybe it's like, even though I fly a lot, it's still maybe airfare.
Sure.
Any plane ticket I look up, I'm like, that's way more than it should cost. Mm-hmm. It should be like half that every time.
It's because it varies so much. Like, I flew to LA, usually when I went to see Meg all the time, it cost me like $600 every time I went there.
Yeah,
but this week, I flew there for $200.
Like, to me, it's like $500 should be the most a domestic flight should ever cost. And that takes you to, like, Seattle or New York for us. That takes you L.A. to New York, like, all the way across the country. But if I'm flying, like, anywhere else, it should be, like, $200, $250. That's not the case. You can occasionally get that, but it's like, no, that's like $400 every time. It's a lot of money, dude.
Yeah. Flying's expensive. Why is flying so expensive? Fuel is so cheap now.
I don't know why it gets more expensive as you get closer to a plane taking off. If I'm at the fucking door to the plane and there's empty seats on it, I should be able to give them like $100 and get on.
Right.
And that's my risk is that I won't get a seat on the plane, but I should pay less, not more. If I pay at the cash at the door, it's like $1,500. No, it goes way up. If you try to fly the moment of, it goes way the fuck up.
Yeah. One time I did that coming back from Portland. I finished work early, so then, like, ran down to the airport. I didn't have a return ticket. So I was like, oh, there's a flight. I can leave this work that I'm doing. I can go down to the airport and try to get on this flight and make it back to Austin. Went down to the airport with Jason. Both of us were there. We're like, we need two tickets on that flight. It's leaving in 45 minutes to fly to Austin. They're like, oh, we're sorry. It's all sold out. All that's left are first class seats. I mean, how much is first class? $600. Like, okay, that's not bad. That's not bad. I was like, all right, fine. We'll take those tickets. You know, they print up the boarding passes for us. And it's like just covered with the letter S all over. And I'm like, what is this? Like, oh, no, you're fine. Just go through security. It's for secondary searches.
Yeah,
once
you
get to security. And I guess because I showed up and bought a first-class ticket like 45 minutes before the plane showed off, I got extra fucked by the TSA
at the security station.
All kinds of butt stuff.
Yeah.
I figured they'd make that less obvious on the boarding pass.
No, it's just like covered in S. So one time coming back from Australia, Esther's printed out her boarding pass, and I looked at it, and it had like S. I was like, oh, you're in trouble.
You're done for.
they're gonna love going through your stuff.
They're gonna make you feel things I never was able to make you feel.
I just had a really terrible day of travel for some reason. I got to the airport really early, which was luckily because at LAX, there's a whole terminal for American Airlines, but there was one flight that wasn't in there, and it was my flight to Austin, which was from the international terminal.
What?
The Tom Bradley terminal.
Tom Bradley sucks.
There's no priority line, there's no pre-check.
He's sad somewhere.
So you have to stand in line with like everyone who's going to all over the world.
Oh, and with regular
like,
people?
It took like an hour and a half. No, I mean, just like, you don't expect, you don't budget time.
I'm trying to sabotage you over here.
You don't budget time for like international travel when you're traveling domestically. But I'm in the line for international security.
Oh,
which takes longer anyway.
It does.
So it took me like an hour and a half.
He's international.
And then the plane almost hit nothing.
They're all suspect.
I can't believe they flew you out of Tom Bradley. It doesn't make any sense.
Apparently, they just ran out of gates.
So weird.
And that flight was not full. I guess a lot of people missed the flight. Because
one of the only good things about living in Austin is that you never actually do fly international anywhere from here. So you still just show up an hour before.
There's apparently a flight to Toronto from Austin.
There's going to be a flight to Frankfurt. He can fly to London. Typically, you don't fly. But there's also a flight to Cancun.
Mexico.
Cancun, Mexico.
Oh, hell yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I want to go to Cancun. Let's go to Cancun.
Is it nice? In Cancun?
You were going to go, but then didn't go at one point. Because that was a trip you guys were going to take and then didn't take. You guys, weren't you going to go on vacation with Meg there?
Laser team was coming up.
That's what it was.
Cancun.
I was told not to be gone.
Which is like, for us in Texas, that's like super close. Cancun. That's like a 2.5 hour flight.
Is it really?
Oh, it's not bad. It's not bad at all. Yeah.
Damn.
It's like right across the Gulf of Mexico.
Yep.
Or is it called in Mexico?
The Gulf of Mexico?
Golfo, right?
Golfo. Did you see our vote? Yo, vote. Oh, you can't see it on the camera.
Yo, vote.
Did you hear about the
are you comfortable saying who you voted for?
I don't know.
Is that too political?
I don't want to get too political. People get mad. Like, we talked about...
It rhymes with Monald Mump.
No.
What was it? We talked about something that was vaguely political once, and people got really mad. I didn't even
say the superdelegates thing?
Oh, no. It was like the thing about bombing the country from Aladdin. Like, we didn't even politicize that. Yeah. We just, like, mentioned that story, and people got really mad.
Felt offended.
Yeah.
Did they really?
Yeah.
Did
you, really, people were like, oh, I'm not listening to the podcast anymore. I was like, yeah. It's just a story. We didn't mention any political parties or anything.
I wish anything was, like, that important in my life that I would give up something that I enjoy that's entertaining. Like, as soon as I heard anything about it, I'd be like, that's it. I'm done. Like, I don't know what that would be.
Yeah, I can't like imagine watching a TV show and then I get offended by a joke and never watch it again. Unless someone in the show reaches through the screen and like shoots someone I know, I'm not going to be that annoyed by the TV show.
Right. I'll be like, oh, what a shitty joke. Yeah. And then come back later. Like, remember when Colbert, the whole hashtag cancel Colbert, remember when that went down?
Vaguely?
Yeah. It was he was making fun of the Washington Redskins.
Oh. Yeah.
And he made some like Asian joke or something like that.
I don't get it when people call people problematic.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I've seen it so often on the internet these days, someone calling someone problematic.
Uh-oh.
Well, like,
and it's like, is that like you like that person, but they're prone to saying things that offend you?
It just means controversial, surely, doesn't it?
Maybe.
But it's a problem again. It's a problem.
I'm seriously concerned about it.
I don't know. I don't really understand it.
Yeah, but there are definitely people in the world that's like hard eject. It's just like, at the moment they hear something that goes against their beliefs, they're just like,
Get a grip.
I'm just like, I'm out. Abort. Not going to have anything to do with it.
I mean,
is this video ready?
Abort.
The video that in no way shows the problem.
You got it?
It's really tiny. You texted it to me.
Oh. Why'd you text it to
me? Gavin?
Could you just airplay it?
Stop with it.
But it's a low resolution. That's
the
problem.
All right, you know what?
Google Drive.
Patrick?
Yeah?
They don't deserve to see the video. I don't want to show it to them.
Show it to us, Patrick.
Are you saying our audience doesn't deserve?
Are you about to read an ad?
Yeah.
It's funny.
Oh, wait.
Stop it.
Stop. I'm saying wait. I can't believe you're not stopping.
So the Martian. I can go pull it off my...
Go do it.
Like you sent it with a Game Boy or something.
I sent it over text.
Go do it.
Because I didn't have the damn thing.
All right, go. Bernie's going to ruin another ad read.
I'm going to be fine. You're going to be okay.
Get out of here. He's not leaving. All right. I want to remind everyone, this episode of the podcast is brought to you by Braintree. Developers around he's back. Developers around the world have embraced the Braintree V.0 SDK as the easiest way to add secure mobile payments to their apps and website. Don't have time? Give them a call and they'll even handle the integration for you and walk you through it. No matter what payment type, Braintree accepts it. Apple Pay, Android Pay, PayPal, Venmo, credit cards, even Bitcoin. And if something new pops up, Braintree will support that too. It's the same payment solution used by Uber, Airbnb, and GitHub, so you know that it scales. We should use it for Suber. Integrating into your app is easy as inserting a few lines of code. Try out the sandbox and see for yourself at braintreepayments.com/roosterteeth. It's braintreepayments.com/roosterteeth. Thanks to Braintree for supporting this episode of the podcast.
Oh my God, that was so weird feeling.
That's what she said.
I thought like a piece of my hair got caught on the couch and then I realized it's the stick.
A couple of weeks ago, I was in LA and I was flying out and it was one of those deals where I was there with a coworker and we were in a business meeting. and we had, you know, an hour and a half, maybe, before our flight, and we're in Hollywood. We're like, oh,
for LAX?
Yeah. Ooh. We're like, oh shit! Like, time stuck up on us. Like, we can need a haul ass, and it was like 4:30 p.m.
Traffic Central.
Yeah, we're like, we need a haul ass to LAX. We got back to LAX, you know, had a rental car, and so we got a silver car. So we go, and then like they race us to the airport, you know, had pre-check, so like got right through the line. Walked up to the gate with literally like 2 minutes before we boarded.
That is awesome.
It was like literally, I was like, this is the perfect amount of time to get to the airport.
I would travel like that all the time if there wasn't so many variables that
could. Yeah, it was traffic. Traffic could have fucked us. When we were on the way there, I saw a wreck happen in my rearview mirror.
Oh, no way.
Yeah, and I was like, if we had just been even 30 seconds later, like we would have been stopped. We might have been in that wreck or we would have been delayed by that wreck.
That's true.
Did you see the video of the guy whose brand new Mercedes broke down on the freeway because it was smoking?
Yeah.
And then it caught on fire?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
The guy like becomes unintelligible at one point.
He was not happy about
that. Whoever's with, her name's like Lisa or Nancy or something. He's like, Nancy, my car's smoking. What's wrong? It catches on fire. And he goes from saying that, like, Nancy, my car's smoking too. he just goes like to this register that you can't even believe. And then the guy posts the video online. I was like, why would you do that?
Yeah, you see like the fire engines pull up and start trying to douse it and put it out.
All right. I'm going to get this damn file. Should have done this earlier in the week. Ain't going to be worth it. Not going to be worth it.
No, it's totally going to be worth it.
this is worth it to me.
Shut the fuck up.
Do you want to
faff about with
so much?
So I saw.
You could have just emailed it.
I don't know what he's doing.
I can't email it. It won't let me. Because it's too fucking big.
Why don't you plug your phone into another computer? Why are you putting it in
there?
Because
they're not set up to handle it.
To an iPhone?
They don't have USB ports?
I don't want to deal with it. They don't.
What does that mean? They can't handle it.
Also, there's mail drop. There's Google Drive. There's
a million ways to do this.
Listen, shut up.
This is why he can't fix his TV problem, Gavin.
he's just
like looking
now
at
I'm
it.
Now I'm definitely not doing it. He now shuts it's up. Gus, listen, I'm really not gonna transfer.
No,
this
I want to see
Rooter
it.
For everybody. I don't care if you want to see it. I don't give a fuck.
Please.
Gus Rooter for everybody. Fucking dickhead. Fucking asshole.
It's his birthday. He's allowed to be an asshole.
You don't know how tempted I was when I walked to go get this. I had to go walk by the front door. I thought, I'm just going to leave. I was literally just going to walk out the front door and just keep
really
going 40 minutes before the end of the podcast. Just never come back.
That would have been really funny.
It would be a first.
We had a little sword fight earlier. We could show that in the meantime.
Wait, what?
Yeah, Gavin and I had a sword fight.
Do you know what that means?
They fought with swords?
What does it mean, Barbara?
You fight with your dicks like they're swords. A sword fight.
Nobody does that. Who's ever done that? I've never known any dudes who have ever actually fought with their dicks.
Your mom.
Very good, Barbara.
Nailed it.
Did you see there were a couple of
68 meg file and I can't send it over the internet? What fucking year is this?
Everyone can.
Shut up.
There were a couple of somewhat related news stories that really pissed me off this past week. There was that group of people on a beach in Argentina who saw a baby dolphin in the water.
And they killed it.
How infuriated are you by this story?
Wait, what?
They picked up the baby dolphin and brought it onto the beach and they started passing it around to a crowd of people so they could take selfies with it. Fucking rare baby dolphin dies because they took it out of the water.
Because they didn't want to put it back in the water because everyone wanted a selfie with it.
Yeah, it like died of dehydration out in the sun.
That I don't want to live in this world
And
anymore.
Then today, earlier today, I read about another story about a zoo in China with peacocks where the people who were at the zoo like caught one of the peacocks and held it and then they started passing it around so they could take selfies with it and the peacock died. It had a fucking heart attack because it was so scared because people had picked it up.
And imagine like
at a zoo?
Yeah.
Why are they picking up a peacock?
Would there be a zookeeper being like, don't fucking touch the animals?
I don't know. And I think they also started while they had picked it up and were taking selfies, like people started yanking its long feathers out
of
its tail.
God.
What's wrong with people? What's wrong with people?
It's a fucking animal. Right? Who would do that to a defenseless animal?
But it's a lot of people. That's what's scary. It's not just one person doing this. It's a group of people.
Yeah.
Well, they're in a frenzy. They don't want to miss their chance to get the selfie. Because it's not fair. Everyone else got to take a selfie with the dolphin. Why don't I get to take a selfie
with
the
dolphin? It's so fucking infuriating. It makes
also, aren't they thinking, oh, it's a dolphin. It lives in the water. Maybe we should put it back in the water at some point so it could actually live.
Oh, they put it back.
It was dead when they put it
dead.
Back.
It's an awful
video. All right, Patrick, I just shared a link for...
I've got the video.
Well, how do you have the video?
He wants the higher res one.
It finally came in through email?
Yeah.
Oh.
I sent that at the beginning of the podcast. I also shared it on a web service.
It took...
And it made me put a message along with it, so sorry about the vulgarity on that.
It took almost an hour for that email to get there.
So I did, see?
This no, is what's wrong with the I never doubted planet. You.
What? The version
Wait,
the version I sent to you on the drive thing is it's probably a better version. It's probably a higher res version.
Also, Gavin was talking about the sword fight that you guys had. I think they actually filmed that in the control room.
I didn't know that.
It's not exciting.
I think they
it's
did.
Me whacking Gavin on the hand with a bamboo stick. Here, let's have a live reenactment.
Oh god!
But you're much more angry than you were earlier.
Ouch!
Jesus!
Come on, Gavin. Here, take it. Oh. Don't hit me though.
She's not a baby dolphin.
The rule is.
Ow! Oh, it hurts
the
so
rule
bad.
Is you have to hit the hand and you can't hit eyes.
I don't want to play.
Why
this.
Why are we doing this? No, let's just watch a video.
All right. Well, Patrick's done with
his thing.
Let's
watch your
video. So listen, this dolphin thing really makes me super sad. We gotta give up on the fucking selfie thing. Like, you know, there's people who have posted photos with them and that fucking dolphin.
Right.
On their social media stuff and their Facebooks
still,
or whatever.
Poaching is still way worse than selfies.
Why is poaching worse?
Because more dolphins die of that than getting selfied.
Okay. Well, I mean, if you had to pick why a dolphin dies, you had to pick it. One dolphin dies because people wanted a bunch of fucking selfies with it.
Eliminating
a
the selfie.
A baby dolphin, too.
Eliminating the selfie won't save dolphin lives.
It would have saved that one.
One dolphin. I mean, it's
okay.
Sad, but it's
okay,
like...
Okay, Gavin,
still
you're right.
Killing
so let me give some
time.
Advice to our podcast listeners. Hey, we got to stop the selfie thing and all the poaching that we're all doing.
No,
so
yeah, no,
if
no,
you could, after the podcast, if you could just not poach, thanks.
I think Gavin's advice is...
Who the fuck do you think is listening to our podcast? There's some dude on the fucking fishing boat outside of fucking Tokyo going, oh, man, he really got to me
really
on that one.
Gavin's advice is
fucking
asshole. Take all the dolphin selfies you want as long as they're still poaching. That's what you're saying.
Wait, how did you get that
I'm
from that?
That's what you're saying.
Argument.
You're saying the selfie thing doesn't matter as long as they're still poaching. So people fucking kill dolphins. Take them out of the water.
How many dolphins died of selfies?
At least one. The one we're fucking
Bro,
talking
did
about.
Did you get a mass message about one case? Probably not.
Do you want to tell our audience not poaching? You're going to tell our audience not poaching? Our audience can stop doing dumb selfie shit. They can't stop poaching because they're not fucking poaching.
I just feel like
poaching.
Not many things are getting hurt by that. Compared to, like, giant trawling fishing nets.
So you're saying telling everyone to not eat meat.
I'm not saying anything.
All right, fair play.
I just got this stick.
You had the photo on my fucking stupid TV, which doesn't even matter now.
It's a video.
All right, see, I'm pulling it up.
They're pulling it up.
Okay, jerks. This is what I'm talking about. Here's the TV. It is a projection TV. It goes directly into the wall. They built the wall perfectly around the TV. There's the fucking cord that I had to use to play Xbox. This is it. And it's a projection TV, so it goes in and then goes down. And so there's a hole. There's a gigantic hole right there. I can't hang a TV over a hole. Do you agree with me?
You can't mount a TV to a hole.
Jerks.
Yeah, you just take it out.
I still don't understand. I gotta say, control room, if after all of this, if that played without audio, it's on you at this point. It took 3 hours to get you that file, and there's 12 of you guys
in there.
There's 12 people in there. I gotta hear from the audience on Twitter whether or not that played with sound, because we cannot hear the sound. If that had no sound, that's it. I'm gone.
You still got
I'm
to
out.
See this, though.
I'm leaving. All right, the audience is on Twitter. They are very sorry about the poaching, Gavin, and they will stop immediately. Poaching. Poaching dolphins.
Well, all of our audience, think about the difference we just made. Millions of people are going to stop poaching dolphins
we
now.
We reduce poaching in our audience 100% with
this
podcast.
We saw it dive to zero. We really made a difference today.
I feel like you both know what my point was.
Just got a message.
Your point is stupid. We know what your point was. Yeah, we're not saying we don't know what it was. We're saying your point's dumb, Gavin.
Just got a message from the Rooster Teeth Dallas-Fort Worth community group. They have canceled their seal clubbing event for this weekend thanks to Gavin and his messaging. So, good for you guys. Wow. Sorry to ruin all your fun. Baby seals deserve to live, too. Yep, no audio. They played it without audio.
Edit in after the fact. When it goes public, they'll hear it. When it goes public, they'll hear it.
No, but this conversation should be left in.
This conversation will be left in. You will know that we did not hear it.
And the sponsors who paid money got the no audio version.
Well, it'll be the rare version, the audio excluded.
It's a moment of solidarity where our sponsors can say, I was there.
What are we doing? It's an audio podcast.
Video. There was really on the audio podcast. That's like a minute of just nothing.
There was a minute. You think they can hear it?
No, they definitely can't.
No,
they're muting it.
Nope. No, it's muted.
We're all doing great.
That was the video.
And also people are taking selfies with Barbara now.
Yeah.
On the podcast.
Well,
I selfie the selfie argument.
What we learned from that video, when there is audio on it, is that that video didn't show us anything.
That really. Video is very descriptive. It shows you TV goes into the wall and goes down.
This is exactly what you told us on the podcast.
That's exactly right, Barbara.
But
that's
it still doesn't explain why you can't just take it out.
Because you can't cover a hole with a TV.
Yes, you can.
TV looks like it covered the hole. Its edges came out over the lip.
Because it goes all the way to the ground. I'm not going to buy another TV that goes all the way to the ground.
Are you talking it doesn't have a thing for
mounted.
The stand?
I'm mounted on what?
The stud behind it in the wall.
There's no stud there.
Why is there no stud?
How
they
does
carved
that?
It out to put the TV
but
in the wall.
There's a wall somewhere. What's the back end go up to?
The back of a cabinet behind it on the other side of the wall.
Okay, there you go.
So what is
I don't know, mount an arm to that, the back of a like a flimsy little
yeah.
back of a cabinet.
What's the current TV hooked up to then? How is it floating there?
Barbara, I can't explain this anymore. I can't explain this.
I got that part. It's like a big projection TV. It's older, so it's got like a big base and a stand.
Okay, so why don't you get a
TV goes into the wall and then goes down all the way to the floor.
So it has a big long stand that
yes.
No, Barbara, we're done with that. We know it has that.
I'm finally understanding.
Say,
Barbara gets it.
I'm
say you get
it.
An 80-inch TV. You just get one of those bar mounts that goes flat on the wall, and you drill that over the.
Yeah, you could get a stand like what we have our TVs on
so
here.
So I put it
that
over
in the wall.
Cabinet.
Yeah, why not?
Like drill into the cabinet. Well, I could do that. I mean, I could drill it to the cabinet, but that would seems like it's very insecure because it's like decorative. Yeah,
you
wood.
Could stick one of these posts in your wall
yeah,
and just
get
mount
a big
it to
stand.
That.
Just put it on a C stand.
I mean, I just don't want to talk
these
about
posts are really good. They're that's what they're intended for.
Or take out the TV, get a nice picture.
This is the first time ever I've ever looked at the clock, so we had a half an hour left, and I was disappointed. But I have to spend another half an hour with you fucking people.
Is this the most mad you've been though on a podcast?
What's that?
No,
Gavin, I'm just disappointed.
I almost saw his iPod that one time.
I'm not mad. I'm just disappointed. I'm upset about the dolphin and the selfies. Listen, if somebody, I want to see if somebody has a, like, somebody who listens to this podcast probably knows somebody in their network that had posted a photo with that fucking dolphin as a selfie. Someone posted that somewhere. Those people should be running scared. They should be ashamed of that.
They didn't, I mean, yeah, they didn't think it was going to die probably though.
But
they
still,
took it out of the water.
It's out of the water.
Yeah, but
I mean,
it's
they
a
did
dolphin.
That in Free Willy.
Somebody in the control room
in
just
the
let out a,
movie Free Willy?
Such a disappointed sigh. Just like, oh, Gavin.
So it must be true, right? Everything in the movies is absolutely true.
Just gotta keep them wet.
But they weren't.
Yeah.
He's on the dry sand.
Obviously, the people who were taking selfies did not watch Free Willy.
Oh.
They tried to Free Willy.
What?
What?
You can't say what back.
What? What? What?
Oh, should we just have the shortest podcast?
Should we just have the shortest podcast
just
walk out of here?
I think Bernie's done. He's too mad.
I'm reading Twitter. That's how upset I am. Oh, no, I'm good. I'm good. I'm just trying to find what. I'm getting mad as I read Twitter. Someone just wrote, so you have a hole made specifically for this TV. It sounds like you have a personal issue. Stop talking about it. It's like,
what?
Fuck, stop listening
to stupid
it.
Podcast.
What do you think these are about?
We never talk about personal issues here. I'm going through a bit of an experiment right now.
Just put a rug on the wall. You people are horrible.
No, it's a tapestry, right? Then a fancy rug on the wall is a tapestry.
Yeah, get a
and
just nice,
you got
get
a
nice painting.
Sweet hiding spot.
You got a secret room.
It could be your panic room if anyone breaks in your
I
house.
I still want a TV there. I still want a TV. I'm you people are no help.
Can you not just put it on a different wall? Actually,
I probably yeah. No, in that room I probably couldn't. Ooh. I'd have to put it over the fireplace. I don't like TVs over fireplace.
Too high.
I agree.
You
with
get
you. They're
cricked neck.
And I can't do it in any other place because the other wall has built-in bookshelves and the other wall has windows.
Stuff like
you know what you should do?
Booked.
Too many
put it over the fireplace and then
mean?
Play the
I
fireplace channel.
Is that like a weird thing that a person has bookshelves
no, but if it's built
in their
in,
house?
If it's built in, it becomes an inconvenience.
Just
later.
Like your built-in TV.
It's a wall with bookshelves on it. It's a normal thing. It's a normal thing. It also has a doorway in the middle of it. Is that okay with you guys? I have a built-in hole in the wall to go to different rooms.
Fucking big shot
in
your
fucking
doorway.
Teleport.
Everything we say.
Walk around the outside of the house. Look at me with my fancy doorways in the house. Fucking amazing. God damn
it. Put a rug over it.
Put a rug over it. Put beads like a bead curtain.
Hey, somebody stole somebody else's idea online.
No.
God, what are the chances? Do you remember a few years ago the dude from Prank versus Prank? What's his name? Jesse? Or is that
yeah.
the girl?
No, I think it's Jesse.
Because she's always screaming Jesse, right?
She's Gina.
She's Gina, he's Jesse,
mm-hmm.
right? And he did a really funny, like, public, not really a prank, but just like a public goof, where he set up an electric skateboard to look like a red carpet and then zoomed around on it dressed as Aladdin.
From Agrabah.
Fucking brilliant.
Yeah.
It was brilliant. Well, a dude is getting all this press because he just did that in Japan with a hoverboard or whatever the fuck those stupid things are called. And he made it like look like a cloud, and I guess something from Dragon Ball Z where the dude like flies around on a yellow cloud, the Super Saiyan dude.
Super Saiyan.
Yeah, Super Saiyan. Does he fly around
Super Saiyan?
Does he fly around on a cloud?
I guess so.
Okay.
I don't watch
that. Like, I'm stupid. He's flying around a fucking cloud, for Christ's sake.
I know what you're saying.
So he's like, clearly that's where he got the idea to do that. Clearly that's where he got the idea.
I feel like even that that original video you're talking about, I feel like that was popular again. Like, people just rediscovered that 2 months ago. I feel like I saw that everywhere again. Like, it had just resurfaced some.
It wasn't from 2 months ago originally?
I thought it was from longer ago than that.
I don't know. It's the first time I saw it was about 2 months ago.
I thought he'd made that some time ago.
This is really funny. Somebody pulled the model number of my TV off of the video that we showed, and they looked up a reference photo of it. Look what the reference photo has on it. A dolphin. A picture of a dolphin. So
no fucking way.
Yeah.
Don't take dolphins out of the water.
Seems
just give
like
them hand jobs.
Seems like a short stand for that TV.
You could put a coffee table in the wall and put the TV on that. That's Jonathan Browning. That is the best idea anyone has had so far. It's still a shitty idea, but it's the best understanding of the problem. What was your idea?
I said fill the hole with candy.
You were terrible.
Barbara, you're going to make... Don't make him angry. Don't make him angry.
I have a stick. It's okay. I have protection.
So I'm going through a bit of a forced experiment at the moment.
Pegging?
Yeah, pegging. I'm getting stuff up my butt.
There was a pegging scene in Deadpool.
What's spoiler? Pegging? What do I know what that is?
Pegging is when a strap-on dildo dude gets... is pegging technically... Does it have to be a woman fucking a dude? Or can it...
Why is it called pegging?
It is, right? It has to be. Otherwise, it's just anal sex with two dudes.
I think it's someone who doesn't normally have a penis using a dildo to...
Hence the peg?
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
I think.
It's just a strap-on, though.
But yeah, the act of getting screwed in the bum by someone wearing a strap-on,
I am not
pegging.
Getting pegged.
But also, a woman can peg another woman, but that's not... Is that called pegging?
I think so.
It's called Peggy.
To the internet.
Peggy.
So I just got back from an out-of-town trip, and when I came back, my wife was convinced that we are alcoholics.
Why?
Just now she's
because
having
we
this
might
realization?
Be. So she's trying to see if we can go 2 weeks without drinking.
Oh, is that why you have water?
Why? Why are you doing that?
I was going to say you were pregnant, but...
How come Esther's making you do this? Where did you guys come
because
from?
Because it's my birthday.
Yeah, and so you can't drink on your birthday?
I'll take you.
Do you want to take you out for a drink on your birthday?
Nope. I got to prove that I'm not an alcoholic and I can go 2 weeks without drinking.
What? Who are you proving it to?
Esther.
Kind of myself.
You might die. Did you drink a lot in Vegas?
No more than normal. I didn't go crazy.
We're
going
to find out that Gus needs alcohol to survive.
Surely you're only an alcoholic, though, if you crave booze.
Right, like I'm not like shaking. I don't
have
headaches.
Are you thinking about your next drink of booze?
I am, actually.
Oh.
I really am. You might just be. It has been an incredible struggle not to drink.
How many days has it been?
This is day three.
Really? Do you really struggle with it?
Yeah.
Is that why you've been so grumpy
I
want to
drink constantly. It's been a long 3 days.
What do you think you drink on a daily basis? First of all, do you drink every day?
Yes.
It's literally 7 days a week.
Yeah.
It's entirely possible that you could drink 365 days in a year.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure I did it last year. Unless I was sick. If I was really sick, I probably didn't.
What?
I like the fact that you're like building up this big challenge, and he's like, I might have done that already.
Yeah. I was starting at the top, I was going to come down. Okay, do you think you drank 30 days in a row?
Nope.
No, we went to the
absolutely.
Top.
I think I drank every day last year unless I was really sick. I think I was sick for like 2 or 3 days, so I didn't drink.
I wonder
days.
Why.
Because sick. I didn't drink.
So is Esther doing it too then?
Yeah.
Give me an average day. What are you drinking?
Vodka or gin.
When you hit it like 5 o'clock, you go home.
5.
Yeah, 4:45 you go home.
Have you seen
you go
office?
Home. You go home, what happens? I really regret the fact that Barbara's not officing with you anymore because, like, I don't see Barbara anymore because 90% of my conversation with Barbara was, have you seen Gus? That's really
true.
I'd walk and go,
it was
hey,
a
Barbara.
Great friendship, Bernie. I really miss it.
It was really good. You might be in trouble. You're tucked away.
What do you mean?
You're in that corner in the bungalow still? Is that where you are? Yeah, you're tucked away.
But
people
don't
come see you, do they?
My real friends come see me.
Who comes see you?
Everyone except you and Gavin.
She can't name anybody. I've been in there also, but it was like...
I mean,
I walked past the door and saw
people from
in
broadcast
there.
Come visit me. Meryl and Tyler come and sit on the couch and chat with me. It's very lovely.
All right, fair enough.
And somebody has been leaving fucking troll dolls all over my desk and in my purse. And I don't know who it is.
I don't know what that means.
Do you know troll dolls?
No.
The little fluffy hair?
They have the hair.
Oh, like things go on top of pencils?
Yeah.
troll dolls.
I got you.
Those, and then you should do the fluff with the pen. So, yeah.
I found
those things.
I found one in my office maybe 2 months ago, and I emailed everyone at the company about this, saying,
I remember that email.
I don't know whose this is. If no one comes to claim it, I'm going to throw it out because it's creeping me out. Nobody came. I threw it out.
Maybe that's the reason they started doing it.
And then a month and a half later, there's another two trolls on my desk.
Really?
And then I go home, and I'm emptying out my purse, and I've had another troll in my purse.
How did it get in your purse?
Yeah.
That's creepy if they put it in your purse.
I mean, obviously, they're trolling me. But it's like, who the fuck is doing it?
Are you annoyed?
No. I'm just curious. I just want to know who's doing it. It's like the fart hoofer incident with
Blaine. Oh, that was funny.
So my first guess was that it was Muriel. She says it's not.
Muriel, is it you? What is it? Was it like a reference
or something?
She
didn't respond. Oh, she's gone.
Do you not like trolls or something?
No.
No, you do or no, you don't?
I don't have a strong feeling one way or the other about them.
Great. Now you said it, so it's just going to get worse.
I know. People are going to send these to me in the mail.
Oh, yeah, they'll send them to you in the mail now. All these troll dolls.
Please don't.
Send me the one that goes on top of the pencil so I can do the thing.
Did you all not have those when you were in school? You don't know what we're talking about?
I had troll dolls as a kid.
Yeah, no, they like smell
the ones
bad.
You put on the pencil.
No. I hate the stink on them.
So this made me think of something. Gus, I'm rubbing my hands together like I'm rubbing a pencil back and forth.
Make it a fire?
Yes. Have you been watching the YouTube channel Primitive Technology?
No.
You're going to fucking love it.
Is it the ASMR thing?
What's wrong with you?
I love ASMR.
What does that mean? ASMR is not...
What do you guys say more now? What does that mean or what's wrong with you?
Probably both equally.
Well, what is an ASMR channel? Based on like a guy making huts out of like just sticks and mud?
Is everything just ASMR now? Is that the way that works?
The reason it's well known is because of ASMR.
Well, it is that. The guy doesn't talk or anything, I guess. It's a dude who's like working his way up through technology. And like he had to make fire. This is the dude. So he had to make fire. Is this it, Gavin? Is this the ASMR thing that you're talking about? But once he could make fire with two sticks, then he got to the point where now that he had fire, he could make like these stone discs and fire them in his kiln there. And then that allowed him to then do other stuff. Like, he's showing how his hands are calloused. Jeez. But he doesn't talk the entire time. He doesn't say a word. He just goes and he builds all this crazy stuff. Like, you're watching a video right now. He's about to drill a hole in a rock with another rock. And he just chips away at it for a couple days. And puts
days?
A hole in the rock. Yeah, it must take a while, I'm assuming. How long would it take you to knock a hole in
the rock? Yeah, some of these videos are like
at least a couple hours.
Months go by from beginning to end.
I fast forward about a minute here, Patrick, if you can do that.
Well, tell us more about sublingual film, too.
Oh, was that a thing?
It was just like the banner hat that was on.
Yeah, like when he finally gets all the way through that rock, you're like super happy for the dude. But then he builds stuff that like I had no idea like it would work that way. Like here he is
like,
trying to make string.
And I think that hut behind him is like sticks, and then he slaps like gray mud all over it, and it goes hard.
Yeah, then he mixes mud with like ground up
stone.
How
did you find this video? Because I found this through ASMR.
You see Tom Hanks try to do this on Castaway.
Maybe I watch ASMR videos, so maybe it was just recommended to me.
It's ASMR's goofy, but it's such a good way to find like really weird crap on the internet.
This is so crazy what this guy does. Like, this.
So how many videos does he have?
He's got like 5, but he's working his way through it. So what he's doing now is he showed how he built it with stick, but now he has these stones, he can build this drill tool with cords.
Jeez.
To make fire.
It's way easier.
Wait, yeah, isn't it crazy? I mean, this is like it's so fascinating,
holy
and
shit.
It's like working through how like people like develop technology on top of itself, but he doesn't say a word the entire time.
That must be the best.
And it gets really crazy. Like, towards the end of it, he makes a pump version of this once he gets, like, some clay discs where he can just move a stick up and down, and then it makes fire for him.
Really?
It's really cool. It's a really cool channel, man.
Yeah, it seems like it.
I've been really enjoying it. And I don't know what the ASMR quality of it. Maybe that's why I connect with it, because I like those ASMR
videos. The ASMR quality is just, like, the sounds, the no speaking, and, like, the tapping and that, and the rustling.
I like the idea of no speaking.
Yeah.
That's pretty good to me. Here, I got one more thing to read.
Goku flies around on a cloud called the Nimbus. Thanks.
I was dying to know.
All right. Better off for knowing that.
I want to remind everyone, this episode of the podcast is brought to you by Squarespace. With Squarespace, sites look professionally designed regardless of your skill level, and there's no coding required. They offer intuitive and easy-to-use tools to help you along the way, and you get a free domain name if you sign up for a year. Start your free trial today at squarespace.com/roosterteeth. When you decide to sign up for Squarespace, make sure you use the offer code roosterteeth to get 10% off your first purchase. Squarespace, build it beautiful. And I say it every time, it is so easy. It's literally just, you click on a template, drag a few images onto it. You can even like resize the template and what you want to show on it. It's super easy to use. If your experience with websites is only looking at websites, you can make a website. There, Squarespace.com/roosterteeth. It is easy, you idiot.
I don't. Is that the slogan?
That's the slogan now for Squarespace. It is easy, you idiot. I made that up.
I had a weird thing happen last night. I was asleep.
Genius.
I was asleep and I woke up because I'd like vomited acid into my mouth.
Oh.
I had like reflux.
You should be careful about that.
Well, how do I be careful when I'm asleep? What do you mean?
You should look at like taking something for that so it doesn't happen. I knew a guy who was way older than you, but he developed esophageal cancer because he had like lifelong acid reflux.
That happened to me 2 weeks ago. It's really weird. I don't think I've ever had that happen to me. Like, I was asleep, then I woke up as, like...
That never happened?
Vomit was coming into my mouth.
Yeah.
And I was like... And I, like, had to, like, close my mouth, stop it, and then re-swallow it. And then I was laying there, you know, groggy, half asleep. I'm like, oh, that's so gross. I should go brush...
Yeah.
I was, like, fell right back asleep immediately.
Yeah, mine was probably, like, a teaspoon full of acid. It just burnt so much. And, like, I got it back down, and I was like...
Did it taste like vomit? Or did it taste like
acid? I didn't taste anything. It just tasted like it stung all the way up.
Yeah, acid reflux.
That's in your body this whole time.
My stomach's just cool with it, but my throat's like
right. It's like all right, just stay there.
Well, that happens whenever you throw up without having eaten anything beforehand. It's all stomach acid that comes
out. Bile and crap. Yeah, it was disturbing. I don't know what I was dreaming about.
So, I have this annoying thing. I love my dogs.
Someone suggested that I fill the hole in my wall with a bunch of dead baby dolphins. Too soon.
Too soon. I love my dogs, but one of them.
Oh, you found the one thing that won't get a laugh out of the control room. By the way, the dead baby dolphins. So. Go take a selfie, fuckers.
One of them is a really picky eater. And sometimes he won't eat. And if he doesn't eat, then he just vomits bile.
Oh.
Because I guess, like, dogs don't know. Like, if they don't eat, they can't deal with the bile in their body. So then they have to vomit it. So I get really mad at him. Like, just eat. I know you're hungry. If you just ate, you wouldn't be doing this.
Oh.
So it's really annoying. And I can tell. Like, he gets this look on his face. And he starts licking his nose. I'm like, oh.
So that was Benjamin or Oswald?
It's Benjamin. I'm like, oh, here we go.
How often does that happen?
Normally, I keep an eye on him to make sure he eats. But if I'm not, like, monitoring it, then it can theoretically happen every day.
Human children have this same problem. Where
human children.
They will not fucking eat. They just won't fucking eat. You're like, you make them food, and they're like, nah. And it's just like, I don't understand that.
That's boring.
Well, human children are just like, there's no way they'd make it anywhere they don't fucking eat. Like, you have to sit them down and you say, you're not leaving that chair until you fucking do the thing that everybody did for 300 million years to survive. Just fucking eat your goddamn food. That's it.
They want it later.
It's
time
always
that's convenient.
Yeah, but then later, if they don't eat, then they get fucking cranky and they get a headache and it's your fucking fault because you're the adult. And then you also have to be the asshole and tell them, eat your fucking food. Eat your fucking food.
Is it just
food.
They don't like the food or they just don't feel
eating? I don't know.
Tell us more about these human children.
The human children are the fucking worst about eating food. They will not eat food.
What about dog children?
They all go through it at some stage.
What about cat children?
Feline children are totally different than human children. Feline children know to fucking eat. In fact, dumbass Joe the cat, when he's really happy with me, he does that fucking nursing thing where he just takes his claws and just rips at me this. And I'm like, I understand you're happy. I'm gonna deck you if you do that anymore. Fucking idiot. Human children are the worst.
I went through a period when I was a little kid where I was a vegetarian because it's not because I didn't like meat. I was a vegetarian for a while as a kid because I thought chewing meat was too much work.
You sound like Teddy.
It was like, I only want to eat vegetables because anytime I eat meat, I have to chew it and it takes too long and I hate it.
I wonder what age I stopped. There'd be times where I'd be chewing meat and I'd be like, man, it's been like 2 minutes and I still haven't like broken this down enough to swallow it. And I would just spit it back out. But that used to happen to me a lot because I'd like choke otherwise.
Yeah.
But I wonder when the last time I did that was.
Yeah. I think it was the same thing. Like when I was a kid, I'd be like chewing it forever and like I'm not getting anywhere.
I'd be at the table just like... And then someone like my dad would be like, all right, spit it out. Go on.
Did your like, parents give you like rare steak as a kid?
Nah, like roast beef and that though. Sunday roast.
It's hard to chew that.
Yorkshire puds.
Like you get super British on us.
Got a lot of brisket as a kid.
You ate brisket?
Yeah. I had brisket.
Is there a difference? What's the difference?
Brisket.
Cooked differently. Ah, I got that one. Very good, Gavin.
My ankle.
Why do we even have those bamboo things?
Wait, like, didn't I hit you right here?
I don't know. Something like went up my bone hole.
Oh.
I'm surprised we haven't had an issue with people fighting with those before
I know.
Tonight.
I think it's because they were decorative, so we didn't want to touch them.
Oh, I keep punching them.
But we're getting a new podcast set soon, aren't we?
Soon. I don't want to talk about it too much.
Why not?
So we talked about it last week, and I don't want to keep teasing it that it's coming soon without like showing.
Gavin
and
I have criticisms
anything.
Of what?
The new podcast set.
Yes.
We'd like for them to be heard.
You should, that's what the meeting was about the other day.
That's where our criticisms were established.
I'm pretty sure the creative director's opinions are going to be heard.
I just like to point out, I haven't seen it. Yeah.
You should go see it.
Where's
it? You told me
we would like a good set.
You should tell. You should definitely make your opinions heard sooner rather than later.
We do not want a good set. We want the best set.
We want the best set.
Someone sent us a... someone heard us talking about wanting to get into the oil game.
Yep.
And I'm proud to say I've got my retirement plan here in my hands. We're in the oil game now,
Gavin. Is it your dick?
Someone sent us oil. Sent one to Bernie. Sent one to me. We're in the oil game.
What if that is one of the last
Gus actually did an amazing thing. He walked over and gave it to me.
Yep.
Like, that works. If you send something here and you say, here, give, this is one for you and one for Barbara and one for Bernie, I will distribute those things out to people. I do that. If people come up to me when I'm out of town and they give me something to carry back to the office in my suitcase to give to people at the office, 95% of the time, that does not make it
back.
This
got mailed here.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. This got mailed here. So that worked.
So thank you, Blake, for sending that to us. And apparently he claims that he also sent us the decapitator and our Yetis.
I just threw out the decapitator. So thanks for that.
The decapitator broke. I'm sorry to say.
But your streak of having something on the podcast is untarnished.
Three for three.
Literally, as soon as I threw away the decapitator, these oil cans showed up. Mine is actually, you can't see it. Mine's behind me on the Bernie. Oh, actually, you can barely see it in the shot. It's like, I'll show you where it is. It's right there. Boop. That's it. That's my little thing of oil.
By the way, Becca just messaged me saying that she spits out meat all the time because she can't chew it down.
Becca Frazier?
Yeah.
Because she can't chew it?
She sent out a style guide that we should adhere to when writing and posting stuff about Rooster Teeth.
We had a big debate over something in that.
As soon as I read it, I immediately fired back like, yeah, I'm not doing this, I'm not doing that.
What are you not going to do?
I will not use the Oxford comma because I like pissing people off.
Ugh.
And I will not add...
She's big about that Oxford
comma. You also never use commas.
If a word ends in S, I will not add apostrophe S. I will just put an apostrophe.
How do you know it's someone's comma use?
Your name ends in S.
Right.
Because you have to know that rule.
G-U-S apostrophe.
No.
Gus's iPad.
There's not... No, Gus's. If there's plural Gus's.
It's not Gus's.
Gus's. That... Listen, I'm telling
you. I
agree
with you on this. If there's an S at the end, you end with an apostrophe.
Apostrophe.
No.
Yep.
It's apostrophe S?
It's apostrophe.
If it's plural, it's just apostrophe.
No.
My school was called Lord Williams's.
It's apostrophe S. If the word ends in an S, my name ends in an S. Burns. Burns's ends in
apostrophe.
So wait, what
you
is,
are in this apostrophe.
What
no.
is the Oxford apostrophe. Comma? Is that where you say and?
It's like,
yeah, commas and. For and.
Yeah.
So here's a big debate that I think everyone can relate to. Because first of all, they know I'm right about the other thing that we
talked
about.
Doesn't sound like it.
I've already forgot what it was. What were we just talking
apostrophes.
About? Yeah, the apostrophes. Here's the thing that, here's a big debate we had. We talked about, there was a long debate for a long period of time. Is Rooster Teeth one word or two words? Remember? And we finally sat down one day and said, Rooster Teeth is two words.
Because it is
two words. Mm-hmm. It's two words, Rooster Teeth. So the big debate we had this time for the style guide was red versus blue. Does the verses have a period?
No.
I know because the style guide, it does not.
What, it says no period in it?
Correct.
We actually had a debate. The decision was made now, earlier today, that yes, indeed, it does have a period.
I'll do it.
As of this morning, it said no.
I said no initially because none of the cover art or any of the video
assets match anything.
Ever has a period.
The only
asset I can think of that did have a period was the original Red versus Blue Blood Gulch Chronicles logo that appears at the end of the trailer.
Oh, the big like circle?
Right, the big circle one. That had a period, and I think that's the only thing I can think of off the top of my head that did.
I still see it as a URL, so it doesn't have one.
Versus should have a period after it. That's fine. So if we want to have it Red versus Blue with a period, that's okay. As long as it's never V, just V, unless it's an RVB, like the short little acronym.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. But like, and when people are like red v blue, I in like magazine articles about us, I fucking hate that.
Because it's not the name of the show.
Yeah, it's just some people abbreviate verses with just a V. But I just hate that.
Becca just tweeted me.
What'd she say?
I guess the peer was added after the meeting today.
Oh, is that what it was?
Okay. Yep.
Yeah. Well, Matt is like really opinionated about graphic design stuff. He's super opinionated about it. So
I say it throws the symmetry.
Yeah.
Let me think about that.
It ruins it.
Let me think about that. No, because it's already asymmetrical on that side anyway. Red is three letters and blue is four.
Yeah, but
the verses
like,
makes
the
it
verses
small.
Is like,
if anything, it makes it symmetrical. If you consider the period of character, because red...
People here also don't fucking know how to do Funhouse.
Well, how do you do it?
It's big F, Yeah. And then Funhouse, all lowercase. Some people
Funhouse?
Some people capitalize the H.
It's a big F and then a Funhouse.
Or they put two words.
Some people here don't know how to spell slow.
That is true.
Slomo.
Slomo guys.
Slomo guys.
And you've messed that up before.
No, I haven't. Yes, if it was tweeted, it was someone else.
That,
Ashley's going to Gavin for messing it up. You did mess it up.
Well, no, in my head, I messed it up.
Here's the thing.
I never wrote it wrong.
I don't fuck shit up for this company.
Well, fucking represent.
If someone else is fucking it up, that's
I fuck
problem.
Shit up.
Because you're just being obstinate about the Oxford comma.
Yeah.
You just because you need that Oxford comma.
People are so passionate about it.
Like, Becca is very passionate
I used
it.
To always use it, but then people got so passionate about it, I stopped.
You don't use any commas, though.
I don't like commas. But I don't want to slow down.
Becca is
every
so...
Word,
it's like a run-on sentence,
every
though.
Word should could get continually more important as the sentence proceeds.
I have so much trouble reading anything you post on the site because I'm like, where are the fucking
it's just
commas?
Like, it's just like a brain dump. Everything's just coming out, and it's just increasing in speed as it goes. No slowing down. No commas.
Becca's incredibly passionate about all grammar to the point where... Like, if I feel like if you make a status on Facebook... It's something relevant that happened to you that day. It might have been like the most important thing you did that day.
Yeah.
Sometimes Becca just like bitches about a comma. And that's like the most important part.
It's part of her job.
Yeah. But she's really passionate about commas.
Good. You should be. Commas are important.
Okay. Commas are not important. Hey, we got a little tweet here from Moans a Bird.
Little tweet.
She wanted to let us know. She says, I have a BA in English. Names you can end with just apostrophe or apostrophe S, both are correct. Let me tell you something, Monty. On this podcast, there's one rule is that both ways cannot be correct. We will fight
both?
About it until somebody... Yes, both. Both ways cannot be correct. We will fight about it until somebody is right, and then the other people will have to be wrong and be ashamed of themselves. Also, a BA in English, I will take a large cappuccino. Thank you.
Oh, my God. Wow, get fucked. What was your name? Monica?
Monza Bird.
Monza?
And you just got blocked. No. I'm just kidding. I'm not that big of an asshole.
Yeah, you are.
No, I'm not. I'm really not. But I won't ever. There's no point in my life when I'm ever going to walk into the Achievement Hunter office and go, hey, guys, I need to talk. Oh, Michael, by the way, can you unblock this Twitter? That's, I'm never going to, not in a million years am I going to have that conversation with Michael. Telling
also,
him
people always ask me why. Why did Bernie block me? And I'm like, I don't fucking know. I'm not Bernie.
Here's a good indication why you're blocked. Just look at your last tweet. That's exactly why.
Just whatever you said to him.
I got a funny one the other day where a guy made a new account to get me to unblock him. And he's like, my little brother made a tweet on my account. It's like, I don't want to hear messages from people who let their little brother tweet.
That's the oldest fucking excuse. We've been hearing that since the tech support days.
Little brothers are like the scourge of the internet.
Little brothers always are responsible for whatever gets you banned or gets your account locked or whatever.
I wonder if that was my excuse for my, like, my family is dead post.
Probably.
I wonder if I followed it up with it was my brother.
Like, that's
how
always,
could I be dead?
It's it's always little brothers who...
There's also the story. I don't know if you guys saw the story of a... I'm sure it's happened to a lot of people, but this woman who got a dick pic from someone on Facebook...
And I don't think that happens.
And she messaged him back.
What? I don't think women get dick pics.
They absolutely do.
As often as you hear about it,
they
though.
They absolutely do.
Is it a constant, like, just flood of dick pics?
I guarantee you it is.
As
I
someone who works with Meg Turdy, it's very frequent.
Because you guys send their dicks to Meg?
Yeah, sometimes I'll be in bed. I'll be, like, just waking up. And she'll be like, look at this minging dick. And I'll be like, oh, God.
Where does she get them?
Facebook.
People on Facebook? Oh, because they're her fan page?
I don't know. What? Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
How would you directly send a message to Meg?
You can send
it's a bad thing to promote on the podcast. Here's how. Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry. Tell us about your
That's
dick
cool.
pics.
You
they're
can send
mine.
Messages on Facebook to people.
How, have you ever gotten unsolicited dick pics?
No.
Ever, right?
I've had them on Twitter before, but like that's just like a spam account.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, go ahead. I didn't mean to interrupt your story.
No, it's okay. But there was this woman who received a dick pic on Facebook, and then she messaged him back saying... This is disgusting. You shouldn't be doing this. This is a form of sexual, not abuse, but what?
Harassment.
And I'm going to message all of your friends on Facebook. And I see that you're married. I'm going to message your wife and tell her that you're doing this. And he messaged back being like, someone hacked my Facebook. It wasn't me that sent that to you.
Oh.
Please, you can't do this. It was someone hacked it. You're like, don't. Yeah. It's like fucking bullshit, man. Own up to it.
I think I saw what you're talking about, except the one, maybe I saw a different one. It was a model on Instagram. Who just anytime someone sent her a dick pic, she would just look at that person's account, then like send the guy back a picture of him with his girlfriend or his wife, and they would instantly just write back, "Sorry, I'll never do it again."
Yeah,
yeah. Parents, people send them to their parents too. There's a lot of people are friends with their own parents.
Oh, that's fucked up.
Yeah, I love it. Yeah, I love
just
it.
Don't do it. Just yeah, just
send
don't
your penis
fucking
to
do
someone.
It.
Keep
yeah,
your dick
they
in your pants.
That, they raised that fucking asshole.
And penis. That penis.
And the penis. And then the mother would recognize it.
She'd know.
She better not.
What's that?
What?
You think your mother could recognize your penis in a lineup? Like, if we sent your mom 4 dick pics and one of them was yours.
I think I saw porn about this one.
Do you think she could pick... Gavin, do you think she could pick your penis out of, like, 4?
Absolutely not.
Really?
No.
Well, think of that. When was the last time that was seen?
But, like, she would know, like, circumcised, uncircumcised, a birthmark.
I don't know.
She probably wouldn't remember that.
She would remember if she cut her son's dick or not.
Well, yeah, that she might remember. But, like, a little birthmark or something?
I guarantee a mom would. A mom would remember that.
I don't know.
They remember weird shit like that.
So yours would be picked out of a lineup?
My Twitter feed is now filled with dick pics.
Is it really?
So I'll be done with this for the evening. And I would like to retract my previous statement about the infrequency of dick pics. I have learned a valuable lesson on tonight's podcast about the way that the internet works.
You know what's funny is that a lot of people are probably just Googling a penis.
That's
because they don't
want
to send their own. But
that's
I bet
what I think
some
happens
other people...
more. That's what I think. That's what I was trying to say earlier. Is like that. I'm sure people get them. Like cheekiness, but like that people are taking photos of their own dicks and sending them.
Well, what I would be interested by is
I believe that less.
If everyone is now seeing these Google dicks come at you, someone might think I might as well just take a picture of mine, and he'll never know it's mine. He'll just think I Googled it.
Someone could think that. Let me ask you a question: Is 3 grown male adults have you ever taken a picture of your own dick?
No.
I feel like this
never
has
just
come
like
up before.
Specifically taken a picture of your dick.
No.
Gavin, have you ever done that? You could say you don't want to answer if you don't want to answer.
Not of it. But it has been in a picture.
It's just like the purpose of the photo is not to take a photo of your dick.
No, not done that.
Never done it either. I just never, like, that because you got to take a photo of your dick first.
There was never a moment when you're like, man, this looks real good.
I can no. always look
really,
at my dick.
Have you ever
dick.
Taken a picture of your vag?
No.
See, you laughed when you said
because
it.
Because that never looks good. Let's be real here.
Oh, Barbara.
Vaginas are not pretty.
You only have experience
That's
with
not
one.
True.
As far as I know.
Most vaginas are not pretty.
Most?
What's wrong with yours?
Nothing. Everything's fine down there.
It's sideways.
I haven't even taken a picture of my boobs.
Hers is on 2 different tectonic plates.
Believe me, I'm very proud and happy with the way I look everywhere.
But you're laughing at us. You're assuming we took pictures of our dicks.
Because it's flopping out there.
But you would never...
Well, so is a tit. You can wing a tit anywhere.
You ever take a picture down your shirt? Like this? You ever do that? Yeah. See? It's a choice to, like, take a photo of yourself... naked. There goes Barbara.
Way to go, Barbara.
Someone's going to hack your iCloud account. There we go.
Perfect.
Post
How'd it turn out?
She's so happy.
It wasn't focused. It was just blurry skin.
All right.
So I think that. I think people get, you know, sent
it's
a
like,
lot of stuff.
Why would you take a picture of your own dick when you can find, like, a well-lit, good-looking dick via Google?
It's like a stock photo dick.
And like, right. It's like, I'm gonna send like, a model dick.
I also
and then it's like when you take a Facebook profile photo versus, like, actually meeting someone.
I also want to be clear, too. It's like, if someone sends you a picture of their own dick or they send you a random picture of a person's dick on the internet, it still is offensive. It's still an offensive thing. It's like, I also don't think people that send death threats, I don't think 99.99999% of those people are dangerous in any way. I think they're just fucking idiots. But it's not the job of the person who's receiving that to try to figure that out.
Yeah.
Right.
To vet whether or not someone is violent or not.
Correct.
Once you send that message, you report it, you know, and that person should be punished by the law for sending a death threat to somebody. But I still don't think those people are dangerous people, but I just think they're fucking dipshits,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Distance is everything, too.
What does that mean?
Distance from penis.
What? I still don't understand.
Distance. What do you mean? What is the distance?
Oh, wait. Can I guess?
Yeah, let's go ahead.
I think we talked about this before. Yes.
Are you talking about, like, distance of the camera? Like,
yeah.
Now like getting all Dick Cheney.
If the dick is small, like, not the focus, or if it's just, like,
yeah, like
giant.
If you're really far away and there's, like, a tiny cock, it's like, yeah. Or if you're, like, so close where you can see a shaft skin, it's like, I don't know what I'm looking at.
What do you mean you can see a shaft skin?
Like, all you see is, like a close-up of the skin. It could be that skin.
If you focus your camera at just, like, the side of your shaft... And it filled the frame. It's just like shaft skin. It's not offensive.
You had the same argument with anuses.
Exactly right.
Like,
that's right.
You had it really close up. It's not
just
offensive.
Like one sphincter edge.
Sphincter edge
isn't. You don't know what
is
it is.
sphincter edge.
Oh, he has an injury on his sphincter edge.
He's got a tumor here on the sphincter edge. I'm going to be going in laparoscopically to remove it.
How would you describe it?
I don't know. The edge of the asshole? Oh, man. I got in trouble for cursing on a plane.
Oh, really? Who yelled at you? Someone with a kid?
Yeah. Someone with a kid sitting behind me. He got mad at me. He came about it really weird. Like, if you just said, like, hey, can you stop cursing? I got a kid back. I'd be like, oh, okay, cool. Yeah. He was like, hey, I'm from Austin, too, just want you to know, you guys get kind of energetic when you're talking and throwing around a lot of F-bombs. My kid's back here. If you could just refrain from it. He's like, I know you're getting energetic when you talk. Just if you could refrain from using any of that type of language. I was like, all right, cool. So I just stopped. But I was like, why did he start with the I'm from Austin, too bit? Like, then I got pissed off about that. Like, was he trying to say, like, he's cool also?
I'm one of you.
Yeah, I was like, all right, whatever, Grandpa. Fuck up, sit down. Stop feeding your kid cheeseburgers. He's a little fat fuck.
Wow. Wow.
Sorry, he's a little fat F.
Wow. Wow. Salty fucking podcast tonight. Really salty.
Oh. No, he was huge.
All right.
It's because he's not drinking.
What happened today?
We didn't talk about the couple things left on my list here. Actually, the only thing that's left is talking about the fact that President Obama decided to come visit Austin for a fundraiser on the first day of South by Southwest this year.
Fucking
that is going to be a traffic nightmare.
I'm working from home that day.
Yeah,
You
won't have a choice. There will be no South by Southwest is the big music festival we have here in Austin, and it's going to just choke the city already. And then Obama's going to show up and just. It's gonna be awful. What a day to pick. What a day. And the last thing I was gonna talk about was the crying car video, but I think we've all seen that. So.
We need to play it. We
have audio on our.
You didn't.
They would have audio on that.
You didn't do. Would they?
I think so.
You didn't do the tweet thing this week.
Oh, I didn't do the tweet thing this week. You're right. Did you do one?
Yes.
Here, you do mine. Okay. And then I will go through and I will find a tweet for each of you that I want to know more information about.
Okay.
Go for it, Gav.
Gav, what do you got?
For you?
Yeah, from yes, Gavin.
Yeah,
me.
Let me find it. You can talk about other stuff in the meantime.
Well, you were the thing we were vamping with.
Oh,
dipshit.
Really?
My phone's about to die, or my computer's about to die. All right, I got you right here.
Oh, I looked at it before. Well,
I thought you had a note. You're scrolling through Twitter. I just
remember seeing some of it, but now The Amazing Race has happened since then.
Oh, yeah.
So I can't find it.
Oh, you had a really good tweet about, and you said this when we were in LA, you said this to me and then tweeted about it, that you had an idea for using Touch ID for different functions on the iPhone.
Yeah.
I thought that was a brilliant idea, actually.
Like what?
Go ahead.
For example, I want to program my left index to unlock the phone straight into video mode on
right,
the camera.
Right, yeah, that makes sense.
Because at the moment, you can swipe up, chances are it's going to swipe up into photo mode, probably a selfie if that's what you're last doing. You have to flip it around, flip switch to video. I feel like unlocking a phone straight into what you want is the next step from swiping up from the lock
Is there
screen.
A reason that you can only program two different fingers with Touch ID? Like, no, I feel like they should allow more.
You could do up to
5.
10.
Can you?
I think it's 10.
10?
You could do 10 different fingerprints.
Now you told me that you just did five scans of the same finger.
Yeah, I did multiple scans of the same finger.
But you said you
oh, that's
do
right.
Two.
That's why I can only do two. Because I used to just scan my thumb over and over. That's right. Okay. That's right.
There's a. My bank app has a thing where you could use your fingerprint to get into your account.
Yeah.
Yeah, loads of apps do that.
Oh.
Wow. Fucking shut that down. Good job.
I think he means from the unlock, like from the very get-go, like when you're lock screen, you use a finger to get jump straight into an app.
Not for ID.
No, I would like to just use it at any point in time. Why not? If I put my left finger on the button
to
and hold it there,
like Twitter
then
or something?
It would just open that thing, like a shortcut.
Yeah.
Why not?
As someone who quickly likes to start filming, it's still not very fast.
This came up because I surprised Gavin in the jetway of a plane that we were boarding. I like turned a corner and I was like, wow, that's a sharp corner. Someone could have been standing there. I thought, I think I'll stand there. And so I got my camera ready and I was waiting. I literally got my camera ready just as Gavin
I so wish
came
someone
around
else
the corner.
Came out
and we were both kind of hoping
know,
that somebody
else would
come. I wish
you got delayed.
Yeah.
You know you can force touch on the app. I know you still have to unlock it and get there.
What does that mean?
Yeah. Force touch. Like force touch onto the app, you can set it to go selfie, video, slow-mo, or photo.
Yeah.
But I mean,
not from the lock screen.
But not from the lock screen. You still have to unlock and get there.
I was sick of people telling me I can swipe up after that tweet. I know.
Yeah.
This is quicker than that.
All right.
Okay. B. Dunkelman had a tweet this week. I'm going to use you a little bit, your little part of the segment, to give a shout out to somebody else. You were wishing somebody a very happy birthday this week.
I was.
Who were you wishing a happy birthday to?
Mariel?
Mariel. She's gone, though, isn't she?
She is.
Oh, it
was her.
Bitch.
It was her birthday.
She was.
Little Mariel.
Mariel had her birthday. So.
And then she wasn't here to celebrate with
us. She wasn't even here to celebrate. Did you get a cake the way Gus did?
No, she wasn't even here. She wasn't in town.
Where was she? There was a whole thread about. I think it was on Reddit about where she was vacationing.
Why?
Like, people were analyzing the photo because they thought one of their other favorite YouTubers had also vacationed.
Right. They were like, did so-and-so stay there or honeymoon or film a video or something?
And Gus, is there any tweet in particular from the last week that you would like to talk about?
I don't know. I probably tweeted about that fat kid behind me or something.
Tell us about your trip to Vegas.
It was good. It was
really tweeted from there a bunch.
Interesting. I was there for a show called DICE, which is a B2B video game show.
What does it stand for?
Design, innovate, communicate, entertain. And it's really interesting because
that's a terrible name.
It's terrible.
Yeah, terrible.
But it's every head of a video game studio or every decision maker in a video game studio is there. So for example, one morning I got there a little early because I wanted to get some coffee and answer some emails. So I walked into the lounge, I was getting my coffee, and I look up and it's like, oh, cool, Hideo Kojima standing right next to me. You know, he just happens to be there. You know, sit down at a round table discussion. It's like, oh, cool. Randy Pitchford and Fergus, I can't pronounce his last name, from Obsidian Entertainment are just like sitting there talking about, you know, building online communities. And they're like,
did you just chat to them?
Yeah. They're like, oh, you know, Rooster Teeth, you know, you must have had experience with this. You know, how do you get started? You know, what are the steps? Like,
that's class.
This is fucking crazy that I'm sitting here talking to these guys.
It's really cool, man.
Yeah. And and I also got to see, meet Sid Meier. He did a 25th anniversary retrospective on the Civilization series.
Really? So it's been 25 years since that one launched?
Since Civ 1. And they said that with Civ 5, during the panel, you can watch these panels online. During Civ 5, they could finally, because of Steam, they could finally track how much people play Civilization. They said the average play time on a game of Civilization, that for someone who owned Civilization, was 150 hours.
Average play time. Average. You know there's like 10 dudes, though, that are like 18 hours a day. That are like really pushing that average way up.
And so it was just mind-boggling to think back over the history of the series about all the time. And they said something really interesting. It was interesting to me anyway. They said that very frequently when people walk up to them to talk to them about Civilization, the first things out of their mouth are, oh, that game's the reason I dropped out of college. It's like the number one thing people lead with when they go up to talk to them about that game.
How do you feel about that?
Yeah, I didn't want to say that. Like, after I was like, I will not lead with that one. But yeah, it's really fascinating to listen to.
How much time did you put into that game?
The Civ 2?
Or what you can track on Civ 5?
Oh, I don't know. I'd have to look. But it's really cool as someone who's a big fan of video games to see these people and be able to talk to them as a peer. So it's very humbling.
Going to DICE, I think it was 2 years ago, was my first time in Vegas with you and Alan.
Mm-hmm.
My first time learning how to play Craps.
It was 3 years ago.
Might have been 3 years ago.
Yeah, it's 3 years ago now.
Yeah, you guys taught me how to play Craps, and it was awesome.
Yep, it was a good time.
Did you play any while you were there?
A little bit. I didn't have much time. But yeah, I played a little bit.
Did you win?
Yeah, ended up.
Gus is good at that game.
I'm all right.
Good luck charm.
Yeah. All right, well, let's wrap up. Let's do the post show. All right, well, thanks for watching, everybody.
Not live.
Not live. We'll see you guys next week.
I love you.